You know, I love the country. The air, Max, and Miss Annie Crust Bread. They've been baking it here in the country for as long as I can remember. Fresh every day. You know, you'd have to be a sandwich short of a picnic to eat anything else. Of course, the ducks don't like it. Because there's never any left. Sunny Crust. Country baked, country fresh.
SCN Sport now presents a live coverage of the 1993 Ballarat Football League Grand Final between North Ballarat and East Ballarat. Now, here's your host, Alan Besley.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the City Oval here in Ballarat in central Victoria. It's the Ballarat Football League Grand Final, the last of the Country League Grand Finals across rural Victoria. And this afternoon, we go to see a tremendous battle in brilliant sunshine at the City Oval. Gary Odgers, a former St Kilda player, is coaching East Ballarat, and former Carlton star Jim Buckley is coaching the North Ballarat side, and of course they're going for their 50th successive victory and their third successive premiership in the Ballarat Football League. Magnificent afternoon of footy coming up in the next 3 hours. Let's go to our commentary team, headed up by Rob Gaylard.
Thank you very much, Alan, and good afternoon to everyone, wherever you're viewing us on SCN TV this afternoon. And our co-commentary team, of course, we're welcoming back Shane Hill. We can almost say welcome home, Shane. Ballarat's no strange place to you, is it?
The last time I saw a Ballarat Grand Final, Rob, was 1988 between Ballarat and North, one of the classic country Grand Finals of all time. North were the hottest of hot favourites, and Ballarat knocked them off. So I hope we can see something similar today, a nice close one, bit of hoppo-bumpo. look, isn't it a great day?
Just tremendous. Look, fantastic. Tremendous scene, perfect weather, great conditions, and also joining us in special comments this afternoon, a gentleman who's got a fair idea what goes on here in Ballarat football. He's coached an interleague side to victory. Also, he was coach of North Ballarat, who won a flag. Ian Baker, welcome.
Thanks, Rob, but unfortunately I was the coach that Shane was just talking about that lost that grand final in 1988.
Sorry, mate.
Yes, but that's just, I think that just proves a point here today that really North go into this game very... confident, but still anything can happen in the grand final.
Well, we won't ask you who you're going for, because today you're going to have to be impartial, all right?
Yes, sure.
Shane and I, we can jump on either side of the bandwagon. They are going in as the hot favourite, as you said, Shane. Perhaps the feeling around the town, Ian, around Ballarat, the city itself, leading into this grand final. We know North are the hot favourites. I mean, yet there's an element around the ground here today, turns around and says that East can knock them off.
Oh, for sure. You know, they've had three contests this year, and out of two of them, they've run North very close. In the second semi-final, you'll find that really it was only until about the 10-minute mark of the last quarter that North got going and kicked 8-1. So, you know, that's the sort of how they come into this grand final.
Well, that's part of the large crowd you can see here at the City Oval this afternoon. As I said before, it's in perfect condition considering perhaps some of the weather we had even overnight. But Shane Healy, this particular city really loves its footy.
No doubt about that, Rob. You are spot on. North Ballarat has an unbelievably proud record. They've sent some stars to the city in recent years. Tony Lockett is one name that comes to mind. Paul Hill's another. One of his brothers, Chris, playing in the North Ballarat side today.
Something I'll tell you, I'll jump on the bandwagon here. The three Hills brothers, one Coach Clunes, which is just out of Ballarat a little bit, for those of you who aren't familiar with the area here.
That was Barry, wasn't it?
Barry, yes. There was one at Essendon, and of course we've got one here today. So we've got three brothers out of the one family. I hope they don't come from other families. But they can all play in a grand final side and win a grand final.
Well, I'll tell you what, it would be a fairly unique one, Bakes, because one coached in a minor district league, one's playing in perhaps the best league in country Victoria, and the other at the top echelon of footy in the country.
Yes.
No, the lovable larrikin, or butt in here, the lovable larrikin, Buckley. What's he done for this particular football club?
Well, and he speaks for itself, 49 consecutive wins, going for their 50th today. You know, Jimmy's got his own sort of style of coaching, and certainly, I think that really he's certainly got the boys. He's a very good motivator, and certainly today his form up until now hasn't been brilliant, but I'm sure I reckon he'll really come out today and throw it down.
The grey fox out there, the silver fox, I think he got tagged with this afternoon as the Roosters are about to go through their banner. And East Ballarat, as we've said before, have always been a force in this league as well.
Rob, I was in both rooms and it was interesting. The mood in the North Ballarat room, perhaps a little bit more subdued, I felt. East Ballarat, Gary Odgers really firing up his side. I'll tell you who else was in there, and I know you guys were in there as well. Laurie Ick, one of the famous names of footy of North Melbourne. And he was also motivating verbally. And when Odgers wasn't speaking, Laurie Ick was. And there they are, the Roosters. The Bulldogs.
The Bulldogs. Good luck to both teams this afternoon. Joining us down in Boundary Comments again with us on SCN TV this afternoon is John Dunn. Dunny, conditions down there pretty good for footy, but there is a bit of wind down there that's certainly going to favour the side that wins the toss.
Very much so, Rob. Conditions ideal. Brilliant sunshine is the order of the day here at the City Oval in Ballarat. And despite the rain we've had during the week, the ground's in surprisingly good condition. The centre square area has been covered during the week, and the Super Sopper's been hard at work. As late as 6 o'clock this morning, they've had the Super Sopper out on the City Oval here at Ballarat to bring it up to condition for today's big clash. As you suggested, Rob, there is a slight breeze blowing, and it'll be favouring the scoreboard end or to the right of your television screen, and it may get stronger as the afternoon lingers on. But all in all, Rob, conditions absolutely ideal for today's big clash.
Well, partly cloudy, a light breeze, maximum temperature 15 degrees. Currently it's 13 degrees Celsius. And we're looking forward to a great display of football here on Grand Final Day here at the City Oval. Maybe we might take a look at the team lineups in a second, gentlemen, but there's the East boys going through their paces in the warm-ups. Gary Odgers, I suppose you and I, it's nice to harken back occasionally. And I mean, we've played footy and been associated with these guys in our career. I suppose, for those that aren't aware, Gary played with Golden Point, went down to the league, had a crack at AFL level, and come back and has come back to Golden Point, now changed to East. So I suppose there's no such thing as loyalty to a certain extent, but it's where you, I suppose, you make your bed where you lie in it, don't you?
For sure, but I think Gary's situation was that he had a chance to coach, and this is the reason why he's taken over East Ballarat. His record shows that, you know, he's won two consecutive premierships in a row in 89-90, and certainly a very good footballer.
All right, we'll take a break, and we'll be back with the start, hopefully, and the lineups of these two teams shortly.
Saturday's grand final, East and North. Who's going to win?
North. Not a question about it, is there? Yeah, we're easy. Three consecutive is not a problem.
I guess I live in the East, so I'll go for East.
Saturday's grand final, East and North, should be a great game. Who are you going for?
I tend to think North there. A bit too strong, I feel, but I'd like to see East win it for a changeover.
North.
By much?
No, not by a lot. 3-4 goals.
Probably East enough. A few people in East, so I'd barrack for East, definitely.
Good on
you, mate. No worries.
I'd like to see East win, but I don't know, I think North might have the goods.
City Oval at Ballarat. This is Grand Final Day 1993, and the combatants will be North Ballarat and East Ballarat. Let's have a look perhaps at the North Ballarat lineup as they do their warm-ups on the far side of the ground. And Ian Baker, you would know a few of these guys.
Yes, unfortunately time does come past and you don't see as many as you used to know, but certainly from the back line you've got Danny Holloway, Craig Cushion and Michael Troon. Michael, I think, has played in all 49 games too, which is a terrific effort. Off the halfback line, Hines, Hills and Berry. Centre line is S. Holloway, Lewis and McInerney. Half forward line, Buckley, Kennedy and Quinlan. The forward line is Grant Polkinghorne, Dean Seeley, who's kicked 111 goals this season already, and Johnny Orr, the evergreen. And in the rucks is Brown, Ford and Travis Polkinghorne, and interchange is Whyte and Caius Ryan.
Just as well we had a local there, I think, Shane. I saw the word there, TP Horn. I didn't know what it was for a moment, but the boys have shortened that down. The Polkinghorne brothers, of course, and the Polkinghorne name, been around North Ballarat for many, many years. Let's have a look at the East lineup. And Haseloff, Keating and O'Connell, halfback Simpson, a name that's been around the East club for many years, Stevens and Evans. Jax, O'Connell and Dawson make up the centre line. O'Donohue, Wolak and Blood, Cox, Gladman and Whyte, and the rucks Ford. Now, a lot of good mail around says that this might be Alister Ford's last game for the East Ballarat side. He's pretty keen to get out and have a crack at coaching. Their coach at the moment, Odgers, is ruck roving at Orchard. Very speedy little fellow. The interchange is Cook and Jeffrey. We'll keep an eye on that. Things are fairly tight-lipped in the East Ballarat rooms.
I wouldn't be surprised, Ian, whether we perhaps see Odgers and Buckley go very hard very early. And I would say almost certainly both start in that centre square just to get their sides rolling.
No doubt about that at all, Shane. I think that really they're the two that are going to try and ignite it. And I think you mentioned there before down in the rooms that East Ballarat are certainly fired up. North, unfortunately, after so much success, it is very hard sometimes to get that going. And certainly, I think, really, that is where North have really got to start off well today, because if East can put four quarters together, they're going to have them in real trouble.
I noticed a number of small players on the East side. It would appear, just from the look of the balance of the side, that they really play a fast-moving, pace-style game.
Yes, they do. But talking to Gary Odgers, he'd sooner play, certainly, in a dry conditions. He just doesn't believe his boys are probably physically strong enough in the wet. And I think today certainly suits them. But in the air, they're going to have to use the ball properly, obviously, because they can't be kicking high into their forward line, because they've got some big boys down there, Jason Berry and all those.
It's a good shot out there, Rob. I reckon this is one of the better Ballarat grand final crowds we've seen in recent years, to be quite honest.
I think it is, and of course what we're waiting at the moment on is North Ballarat already have one up their sleeve today. They've just taken out the reserves grand final, and that's what the presentations are going on there at the moment out in the centre of this city oval. A wonderful ground, the City Oval. They've had a few problems over the years with drainage, but it's one of my old grounds and a home ground. I spent some years here at Redan in the Ballarat Football League, and some great memories. Nice to come home. The rooms haven't changed all that much, I must admit, when I strolled through. But it's always nice to come back to the old club, and we always say, Ian, that it's a great level of football, isn't it? Doesn't matter whether you're the greatest academic, if you get out on the football field, you're as equal as the fellow beside you.
That's for sure, Rob, and you meet some wonderful people. You might have some hard tussles on the ground, but I can certainly say that you make a lot of friends, both on and off the ground.
Well, down at ground level, Alan Besley is down there. I know he's been keeping an ear to the North Ballarat side all the way through the week. For those of you that have been watching SCN TV, we did a live cross of training on Thursday night. Besley was down there with Jimmy Buckley. I know he's been listening to see what Jim's had to say so far in this game. We saw him, Alan, very cool, calm and collected. Is that still the case?
Yeah, my word, he even tipped me the winner of the first in Melbourne, Rob. You know, Jim's really on the ball, so he started off on a winning note. He's won a few bob on the first. But that famous number 16, well, in the rooms here just a short time ago, cool, calm and collected, a very confident air in the North Ballarat camp. The message from Jim Buckley today is forget about all the wins of the past. Today is the one you have to win and be part of football history as the Roosters go for their 50th successive victory and, of course, their triple premiership in a row. And I think that they can, with the conditions they are today, the boys really cool, calm and collected.
Thank you very much, Alan. They are a professional side, North Ballarat. In my years up here, everything about them has just been superb, and they probably deserve the accolades that they've got. Superb club rooms. Everything about the club is great. But East, they're there today. They have the chance to turn around and knock off these fellows. John Dunn also has been down there. Now, he's been listening to Gary Odgers. We tried to get into the East room. Johnny, I don't know where you were. I knew you were in there somewhere, but it was a bit of a bun fight to get in there. But how was Gary Odgers treating his players?
As Shane suggested, very, very fired up, Gary Odgers, and so were his charges, Rob. He stressed the cardinal rule of football, you must be first in for the ball today. He asked his players to run all day, run the North Ballarat players off their legs. He said he wanted his players to use plenty of handball to break the game open. And he says today was the day, it is the day, to stand up and be counted. He asked his players to believe in themselves totally. And Roberts, Gary Odgers' last game of football today, and he pleaded with his players to give him something to remember this game by.
Well, that's interesting. Gary Odgers' last game of football, I suppose, for many of Gary Odgers' fans. They would love to see him go out on a winning note. He's been a great contributor to Ballarat football and certainly to the East Club, and even if we harken back to the days before, of course, at Golden Point. His loyalties today are with East Ballarat, and that's where they are. We'll take a break. We'll be back with you shortly. We should be back for the bounce of the ball of the 1993 Grand Final here at Ballarat. Being made at the moment on the centre of the ground, and both teams are lining up, and we should have the national anthem very, very shortly. And gee, there is a great feeling around here, gentlemen. We've been lucky enough to cover the Latrobe Valley Grand Final. We did Bendigo last week. We've done the VCFL game earlier on in the year, and somehow this crowd, this ground, this atmosphere gives me the impression that this one might be number one.
Rob, I was comparing a Meet the Coaches Day at St Kilda yesterday, and the St Kilda people very keen about East's chances.
Thank you.
feeling that you like on grand final day. When the national anthem goes, and I suppose, Ian Baker, it almost puts the hairs up in the back of your neck. You'd love to run out there, wouldn't you?
Yes, it'd be terrific, Rob.
We say that 20 years on down the track. Shane, sorry, we went to the national anthem when you were talking.
No, that's okay, Rob. I was just mentioning how keen a few of the St Kilda people, who are obviously down here in Ballarat quite a bit with the St Kilda links with the Ballarat Footy League, were about East's chances in this game. They felt that East had run them for 3.5 quarters in the second semi. They've got a dry day here. They've got the big ground to exploit their pace, and they gave East one heck of a chance. And I suppose it may come down to that first quarter of an hour, Bakes, in the sense that if North kicks with the breeze and East can hold them, great start. If East kicks with the breeze and get held, it's going to break their back in some sort of a way, isn't it?
It'll be hard to know which way Jimmy will go or Gary will go on this, but I think, as you say, I think North will start slower. I just do believe that East will be pumped up to really get going. And if they kick against the breeze and can hold North, it might just set them up for that next three.
Just quickly, before the players actually go to their spot, some of the good matchups that you would expect to see.
Well, I can certainly Wes Lewis and Peter O'Connell in the centre. Wes is certainly a very skillful player. Peter himself has played, numbers of games for East Ballarat and certainly going to be a very good footballer.
Well, North Ballarat have won the toss, and umpires on screen today, the two umpires you know fairly well.
Yes, got Ian Bedford and also Stephen Haynes. And I think Ian, I was talking to him there before, has umpired some 300 BFL games and 100 games down in Melbourne.
Well, the crowd is starting to disperse, Shane Healy, and this promises to be a bottler. I'll keep my eyes on where the matchups will be, and you can take the first bounce.
You're all heart, Robbie, and in fact, I just saw a horrible incident out in the middle that reminded me of something that happened to me when I was about 10, and it's probably happened to any football follower, standing there innocently on the ground, and they got the leather right in the bot. And I tell you what, on a cold day, Robbie, when you get it right in that bozzer, you feel it for a week, don't you? And I felt so sorry for that bloke.
Well, John Dunn, with the BCFL game, was standing there doing his comments for us, and some little fellow had lined him up and let go with a pass from 20 metres and copped him right on the beak, right on air, and I think he did a tremendous job. Let's hope he doesn't have that problem this afternoon. Some of the great crowd you can see here, and that wonderful grandstand, of course, which is the home to Redan and to the Ballarat clubs here in the BFL.
And a beautiful old historic grandstand, isn't it? And I mean, this is the centenary year of Ballarat football. They're launching their big 100-year book today, and in the background there, the great shot of that marvellous old grandstand. And for some of our viewers, Robbie, who don't know the ground, there's a big fire track there in between, which is the reason why the grandstand's set back so far.
Don't worry, we used to do sprint training on it once upon a time, but the ground was too wet. Well, who are you going for, in a word?
I think that it would be hard place to back against North, but by gee, I think it's going to be a close one.
Shane?
Last time I was here, the bolter got up. I'll go for East.
Oh, I've got to stick with the form side. I'll go with good form. I'll go with North.
Well, it looks like North is kicking with the breeze down to right of screen that we'd call the Wenderee or Archer Victory end. And what have you spotted out here, Bakes?
Well, I can see one match up there. They've got Terry Simpson on to Jimmy Buckley. That will certainly be a furious little attack there for a while, I can assure you.
And interestingly, Buckley not starting in the centre square. I would have thought both Buckley and Odgers would have. Just trying to spot Odgers. He's in the centre square there, talking to his big ruckman, Alister Ford. His battle with Stuart Brown in the ruck will be critical. They've at least got a break even, don't they, North, with the talented Ford?
Oh, for sure. Alistair's certainly been a very good footballer. He does a lot of work in behind the game, you'll find, and you'll see that he's a very strong mark. Young Stuart Brown, he had a season last year with the Geelong Falcons in the under-18 state competition. He's certainly come on this year, and by gee, it's going to be a very good contest.
And I'm just looking, they play a very open forward line, North Ballarat. They've got their talented young century goal kicker, Dean Seeley, the only player within 60 metres of the North goal. The Roosters, North Ballarat in the black and white. East Ballarat in the red, white and blue, attacking into the breeze. And they've got a free kick right at the start, going to the underdogs, East Ballarat. And it's going to be taken for them by their captain coach, Gary Odgers. So he's right in the centre of the City Oval, directs play over to the grandstand side. You can see the breeze making a little bit of an impact there. Up they go, and it might be the little boy Gladman to come down with the footy. Gets a good lead. This should be an East grab, and it is. Up at full forward. Nice lead. Good mark from Marcus Wolak. And I had a look at Wolak moving before the game, Ian, and he's a nice size, and I'll come back to you in just a moment, but he's going to shoot from inside 50 here. And it's a good kick, too. That's a great start for the Bulldogs. A goal to East Ballarat in the first 30 seconds. And look, he moves quickly and a good size, that kid Wolak.
Yes, Chris Hills is certainly going to have his work cut out there. I think that really both centre-half forward areas are going to be critical areas here at the moment.
Gladman with good vision. Saw the lead coming out there and it was placed to perfection. As Shane Healy said before, what a great start for the underdogs and against the breeze too. Back into the centre of the ground. Umpire about to put the pigskin into the dirt again. Forward gets the tap down. Tap forward by Quinlan, it was for North Ballarat. A chance for the Bulldogs to go forward again. A scrambly old kick, but it's going in the right direction. Here's a race, 2-on-1. The tackle there by North Ballarat. That lets the big fellow in here for East Ballarat, who drives it in towards the pocket. But it's going to be all North Ballarat. They trap it in underneath and they'll bury this one, I would say, because he's surrounded by East Ballarat players as the ball goes over the line and out of bounds.
Big deep pockets on this ground, Rob, and for those who don't know it, of course, you can almost get lost out on those wings, can't you?
And they're a long way from us, I can tell you too. Umpire brings it back in again. Forward, no it wasn't, big handball came from O'Donohue to no one in particular. Here's a chance, Whyte it is, gets off hands, little kick there from Orchard. Danger, into the pocket, oh great mark! Superb mark by Dawson. Wayne Dawson, the Gary Hocking lookalike, has dived to the ground. Now, at no stage did he have his name. Have a look at this. At no stage did he have his name on this.
Yeah, it's very good, Mark, Rob. I think that what we said before, East are certainly pumped up. They're really putting it on North at the moment. They're kicking into this breeze.
Let's see what Dawson can do with it. He's 20 metres out, splits the middle. The Bulldogs have...
North Ballarat forced the ball forward for the first time to attacking 50. Seeley let out, but the long kick may roll through. That's a good reply. I reckon it might have been Chris Hills.
No, it was Andrew Ford.
Chris Hills, and also the experienced Johnny Orr involved in that passage of play. A North one goal, East two goals. We've only played 4 minutes. Here's Ian Baker.
Yes, very quick out of the centre. I think just very vital, this centre break here at the moment, and both teams are certainly using it to their advantage.
And a pretty good bounce too. It bounced on the edge of the square. I suppose in a grand final, Rob and Bakes, you need everything running for you, and the bounce was perfect.
Doesn't matter how they go through. The ball back in the centre. This is full of action. Forward it is. Pushes the ball into the ground. East have the numbers of the ball. O'Connell, Peter O'Connell it is, drives it out wide. Got a player underneath it. This is Wolak. Been busy early. Second touch down towards that forward pocket. As we said before, it's very, very deep. And in fact, that's going to go over the line out of bounds about 2 metres around from the behind post of East Ballarat. That's the city end goal that you're looking at. And we'll make that 3.5 metres. Umpire moves around a little bit further. Forward, in front, over the back, looking for a rover. Oh, clever. North player, I couldn't quite pick up who it was, but he got boot to ball. Now this allows East back in, and they fire from inside 50. Let's have a look. I think it's offline, or is the mark going to be paid? It's that player again, Dawson. Now it's either through from behind or a mark. I think the mark's going to be paid.
Yep.
And Dawson on a very, very acute angle. No one too keen to make a move, although I can see a player now just in there starting to find a loose hole. Now let's see what he's done with it. This is superb. What a start. The banana kick, and it's through.
Oh, that is a great goal from young Dawson. Two kicks, two touches. Oh, you couldn't start a grand final better, Ian Baker.
No, it's a game of offensive side at the moment. I think really the both back lines have got to tighten up a lot here. We're seeing the forwards really running right in both sides here at the moment.
Well, let's have a look at that scoreboard. Three goals on the Gillies Pies scoreboard. East Ballarat, they've obviously had a few Gillies before the game, and North just the one straight. And the ball's back in the centre. Ian Bedford puts it down and Ford wins it and wins it comfortably. We haven't seen Jimmy Buckley in the action as yet. A little bit of a scrimmage. Was that a high tackle? Umpire said yes. It's against you, Scott O'Donohue. It's going to go the way of the Roosters. Hand pass across quickly to Ross McInerney, who drives long. Down beyond 50. Hills was the target. Good spoil, Evans. Well done. Tony Evans, very important job on Chris Hills today.
Yeah, I think that's a bit of a surprise. Chris Hills gone to centre-half forward, and he was named at centre-half back. And we've had Paul Kennedy swap over with him in the both roles, so that'll be interesting to follow.
Kennedy's been a great player for North. Here's the throw-in, right on 50. Ford got the tap down. Timmy Buckley overran the footy. Well done, Peter O'Connell. Fired across the hand pass, and East able to clear almost to the centre in the only sloppy patch. And lovely handball as Scott O'Donohue links up with Jacks, and he drives long down to attacking 50. North players almost muffed that. It's on the 50-metre line. Big, strong tackle here by the Rover Orchard. Oh, the umpire's letting it go and letting it go, and now he's going to bounce.
Yes, a little bit unlucky. I thought East Ballarat could have got a free out of there.
And lucky they didn't spill the ball out, because Dawson was sitting in the square there on his own.
Umpire puts it into the turf again. Again, forward it is. It gets the tap out. Little kick off the boot there of Jax. Goes forward. North Ballarat just seem a little tentative at the football at the moment for mine. East have really opened up. There's a chance as the ball goes deep into that pocket. Try a Maradona or a la Maradona. Here's a chance for Ford. Thank you. The big fellow has picked up the crumbs as it was, who, as I was about to say, picked it up as a Rover should, but he's a ruckman and he's done a Rover's job and has got a great goal. He's got the tap out in the centre. He's covering more ground than the early explorers, let's say, Shane Healy at the moment, the big ruckman. Here's Buckley, first touch, kick smothered, centre wing. He's driving in towards the diamond. Odgers it is, tries to put his body and forces the ball forward. Good football, actually, from Eastern both sides. If you can't pick it up on the first grab, at least force the ball forward. Here's a chance to set up play. Out on that far side of the ground, running forward is Jax. Jax down in towards the pocket. Who's at home? I think it's going to be North Ballarat, and they'll stem the tie in that last line of defence.
Yeah, Craig Cushion actually grabbed the ball, but I think may have carried it over the boundary line as he attempted to mark that. So we're going to have a throw in. Umpire Stephen Haynes directing traffic there. Eastern attack again. They're 4-1 and into the breeze. Ford palms down, North with numbers there. And they go to clear, Sean Holloway, out toward defensive 50. Peter O'Connell, gee, is he picking up some stats early, and is finding a team man every time, and this time it's Paul Whyte, one of that small brigade that I mentioned before the game, gets the lead. Now, who's at home? Big pack rises, black and white jumpers in the front of the pack, ball hits the ground, Dawson fishes out a hand pass, but the North defenders are going to clear this time. Johnny Orr will give them a lead here on members wing. He loves to run to Orr. A real stalwart of North Ballarat. Tried to put it on the ground. Not a good option for an experienced player. He was terrifically tackled by Terry Simpson, who chased hard. North try and work it down beyond centre wing. Game opens up for Buckley now. Very clever hand pass. He'll get the lead from Sealy. No, great spoil. Well done, and Evans is first back to the footy. Nice one-handed pickup, and he'll clear for East.
East coming out of defence. It was a good pickup by Evans. Here, they're all on their own, and they can raffle it. They turn around. This is O'Connell. Peter it is, in towards the centre. Leading in the race for the ball, there's big Wolak. But interception here by North Ballarat, and they drive it back towards centre half forward. On his own, out there, taking the marker, Sealy. Dean Sealy could read that play before it even left the centre of the ground. It made position, and he's going to kick from about 35 metres out. On a slight angle, and he'll have the breeze at his back. Should not have too many problems making distance or accuracy. The century goal kicker for North Ballarat. Sealy comes in, right foot drop punt. Let's see what he can do with it. On its way. Has he got the accuracy? Goal umpire comes across a fraction. Might have been offline. No. Straight through. Well, I often say some of these goal umpires should join Actors Equity. The goal umpire well and truly filled me on that occasion when he came across. He's got a smile on his face. I reckon he might be able to hear us too, Shane Healy.
I'll tell you what happened. Chris Hills was standing in his way. Chris Hills started clapping, and the goal umpire had to give Chris Hills a bit of a hip and shoulder just to make sure he had the right vision on it, Rob.
Well, I don't think there'll be any reports out of it anyhow.
Well, it's 2-4, and North kicking with a slight breeze. You'd have to say the Bulldogs have done well early, Bucks.
Yeah, very well. No, they're going very well.
Back into the centre of the ground. Doing the ruck work there was Stevens. Picked it up again, trying to get it out off the ground. That came from North Ballarat's player there. They've got it towards centre half forward again. Sealy's behind on this occasion. In front, looked like Stevens, or clip around the neck. Play on, says the umpire. Here's a chance. North, good tackle. This is furious football and good stuff. He's paid the advantage here, and North are going to go. They will.
Hills, Chris Hills.
Now, that was from the boot of Hills. No, it's offline. It must have been touched. I don't know whether you guys saw that or not.
That is amazing.
Well, the East Ballarat player just threw his body over the ball. I thought Hills had an open path to goal, and that should have been a certainty.
Well, I marked it down, Rob. I thought it was through.
I'll tell you how excited I am. I haven't even marked the first two goal kickers down as yet. This is a great game of footy. A great start to the 93 grand final. East about to bring the ball back into play again. 4-0 straight the Bulldogs. North 2-1 on the Gillies Pie scoreboard. Options being shut off by North Ballarat across that half-back line. Look at that ball holding up there in front. Couldn't bring the ball to the ground, was O'Donohue. Chance. O'Connell, handball, out wide. The running player in Simpson, going to get caught. Good tackle. Great tackle put on him by Holloway. Buckley drives it back in towards centre-half forward. Nudged out of the way. Good hip and shoulder. That sent Hills
But here we repel that attack again. East Ballarat, centre wing, grandstand side, stayed in the mud. This is going to test O'Donoghue, and I reckon he might have got into the back of Johnny. No, it's not. It's going the other way. Michael Troon was the player who interfered, and the player taking the free kick will be Scotty O'Donoghue. Grandstand side.
And that's going to be an important duel because the wings on this ground are so big.
Yes, there's a lot of space across the centre line here, and I think that they're working well.
Five-time grand final coach for North, Ian Baker, providing comments today as East try and work it down beyond the centre. Paul Matthew Cox, busy early, gets it up to half forward. Free kick against the Bulldogs this time. Going to go to North.
One thing I've noticed, Shane, umpires, you'll normally notice umpire from 25, 30 metres away. These umpires are umpiring right from behind the packs and the flow of the play, which is good to see.
Michael Hines finds Hills, an important player early for North. He gets it down beyond attacking 50. Big Seely attacks the ball hard and then decides to cross it over. Not the best of options. He might have been better to go with the breeze and have a long kick for goal. And East Ballarat are going to clear. Well done. Nice little turn of speed there by Mark Orchard. Little rover wearing the long sleeves. And umpire Stephen Haight says, throw it in, boys.
Mark Orchard would have to be one of the quickest on the ground, a former top junior athlete.
He always competes at stool each year and, very quick player.
Backed himself there and did it nicely. Half forward flank for North. The run of the ball is their way. It's taken by Lewis, possibly his first kick for the game. Crosses it out in front of Seely. He'll go for the longer kick this time, but he's well tackled. Good work, Evans, of the east side. And he's away. Races away from Jimmy Buckley. Thought about the handball across to his captain coach, but decided to go longer. And Gladman's on a big lead, up beyond the centre. Odgers trying to link out wide. Well done, North's Michael Hines, to put the pressure on. Force it toward the boundary. And the boundary umpire says, I will throw it in.
Good battle.
A was good a good battle. Battle. Yeah, and I like the way Hines knew he had two to beat, and he was desperate.
Back into play again. 14 it is, Stevens. Gets the tap to the ground. It's going North Ballarat's way, though, and they drive it towards that half-forward line. It's going to beat them over the line and out of bounds. 2-on-2, or 1-on-1. And Brett Quinlan using a little bit of muscle on that far side of the ground, just bumping his opponent out of the way. And we'll see a throw-in. We're on the highway side of the City Oval, just outside the 50. And the surprise, if you've just joined us, East Ballarat, four straight goals on the board, and the red-hot favourites, the Roosters, 2-1. That's the Gillies Pie scoreboard. The long arms go up there. And that looks like Stuart Brown on that far side of the ground. It is. And takes a good telling mark. Wobbly old kick, though, in towards the centre. Who's from behind? The flyer. Couldn't bring it to the ground. That looked like Quinlan. It was. Well, player dragged off the ball without it was Sean Blood, and I'd say we'll get the free kick. We'll wait and see. It is. And Blood will take this. No, it's not Blood. It's O'Connell.
He'll be getting close to double-figure position. So Robbie's had
certainly
a big first.
Beating everything. O'Connell drives it out wide. They're not frightened to play that far side of the ground, East Ballarat. And that's where they've been attacking and scoring from. The handball's on. They set up the running game. Chance here for Blood. We spoke about him before. Now he's got a chance. It's not. It's Jax. Jax, half-forward flank, puts it up high. A whistle on play. Let's see what happens. Is it further down the ground? I think it'll be at centre-half-forward or just out. The player to take the free kick is Odgers. Was relayed further down the ground. Good pass. They look good, the Bulldogs. This is Gladman. Now, Gladman should kick this just inside 50 from about 48 metres. The only thing he's got to contend with here, Shane, is that breeze, because if he gets it up high, the breeze will hold it down in that end of the ground. He's got to stay low on the ball. On its way. Oh, it's a good kick. Will it make the distance? Still in play, or has it been punched through? It's through for another behind. So that's their first on the Gillies Pies scoreboard. They move on to 4-1, North Ballarat 2-1. And doing all the attacking at the moment as North Ballarat bring this ball back into play.
Well, it'll be Kennedy to kick out, and he decides to as good as go straight up the centre. This man is dominating. Peter O'Connell, the vice-captain, having a fantastic first quarter. Plays on, left footer, down into the pocket, Dawson again. Wayne Dawson has been in everything in the early stages.
I think, Shane, we said there before, Peter O'Connell and Wes Lewis is certainly one of the matchups, and Peter O'Connell certainly working very well. Wes has certainly not been an influence in the game as much as what we've seen, Peter.
Well, you can see the angle for Dawson. It's a tough kick because that breeze is swirling around. Let's have a look. 40 metres out. Shocker. Miles offline that time. His first two were corkers. That one way, way off the mark. I reckon O'Connell would have had close to 9 or 10 touches. I reckon Lewis lucky to have 1 or 2. And at the moment, it's O'Connell's side east with a two-goal break from the kick-out. Nearly a good mark to the Roosters. The big man there just couldn't drag it down, Jason Berry. They've got a bit of size about the North, and you called it well, Ian. They have started slowly.
Yeah, I think what we said there before, I think they're moving the ball, they're kicking to the front of the to the packs, and they're running onto it.
Big fellow getting the punch out there for North Ballarat with Stuart Brown. Towards the boundary, here's a chance for Buckley. Going to be hotly pressured in a moment. Ball breaks it nicely. The experience tells. And the Silver Fox drives in toward the forward zone. The bouncing ball, but it's East Ballarat who lead in the race. This fellow's played well, Evans. He can read the play pretty well. Not trying to have a bit of a dip and a bounce. He's off. The little pass, this is going to put pressure down the ground as players are going to have to run to the open spots. Stevens, back to 50. They're chipping it around. They're fiddling with it. O'Donoghue. Now he sets it up, far side of the ground. Now they can run. They've got a paddock. Player out here is Simpson. Drives. Half forward. Weight being used and good grab. Look at the experience there. That came from Paul Whyte. Good use of the body. Hip and shoulder. All legal. It's always legal if you get away with it. Here's Smokey.
This is
Dawson gets another one.
he's having a great corner roll.
Let's see what he can do from the other side of the ground. Inside 50. Funny kicking action. But, gee, he's a live wire down there.
Yeah, I think what they're doing, they're bringing it out of their back line east and they're chipping across the other city side and they're coming around the boundary and I think they're just trying to outrun North at the moment.
Every time I look at Dawson, I think of Gary Hocking.
The Buddha.
Okay, they bring the ball back into play again. East starting to get a few points on the board and I think the free kick will go in the direction of North Ballarat here. Now, let's see who it'll go
to. Stuart Brown.
Brown it is, the big fellow. Doing a little bit of ruck work. Brown, drop punt, just to the corner of the diamond in front. That man Evans again nearly pulled one in. Stacks on the mill, and the umpire said, no, you've grabbed him too high. And in fact, there's a little bit of Oscar working there, but I'll give it to you, Evans. You've got away with it. He's going to get caught. Just gets the kick. Evans it is, and this is going to go out on the full. And we're on the grandstand side of this city oval. Well, what a great start. And we've travelled some 18 minutes into this first quarter. 4-2 plays 2-1 on the Gillies Pie scoreboard into the centre of the ground. Good grab. North Ballarat, the big rooster mark. And that player there is Hills. On its way, looking for Seeley. Oh, just chipping in, causing the spoil. East Ballarat, they did it well. Seeley had his name written all over it. Pushed out of the way there was Quinlan, used his body, and we're going to get a goal out of this for North. They say we. Mistake there, Shane. Perhaps East should have been able to be a little bit more desperate there and force that through for a behind.
Yeah, probably their first bad defensive mistake of the day. But here's Whyte getting away again from Sean Holloway. Driving down in deep into the forward line. He was hoping there for Wolak. Couldn't take the mark. And North are going to bring it right across now to grandstand side, where Brown's providing a good option. He and Big Berry have done well back in defence. Hand pass comes across and the Roosters able to bring it down grandstand side. Johnny Orr happy to receive a clinker of a pass. And then the old 1-2 in action. So North from back pocket, virtually the forward pocket. Well played, Michael Troon, in the middle of all that. Big, heavy tackle there on Travis Polkinghorne. But East desperately defending here. Chance for Orr now. Hand passes across. Advantage play. Could be a goal as Hills gives it to Lewis. And he's just missed it. So Wes Lewis has had a bad start. And Hill's beginning to have an influence.
Yes, he is. And we've just seen Wes Lewis starting to set up a few plays here. Certainly North, they don't take long, you know, 5 minutes or so, and they could kick four or five, and this is where the dangerous part of them.
Well, we've travelled to 20 minutes of the first quarter. North with a breeze that we reckon is worth a couple of goals. But East in front by a goal. 4-2-26 to 3-2-20. Brown can't make the kick out. Orr gets a good lead. Chance here for Quinlan. Just couldn't take the mark. Grabs it inside the boundary line. Plays it in front of himself. Then is well tackled. Might have nearly been holding the ball. Not paid.
Well, to me, it's dropping the ball.
Well, I thought it was, Robbie. Travis Polkinghorne gives it to Orr. He's pretty busy there outside 50. Picks out young McInerney. Couldn't take the mark. North players a little bit lucky to get away with a couple of holding the ball decisions in the last minute or so. East's defence absolutely desperate.
Yes,
and on the bottom of the pack, they'll get the free.
I think that's the difference between the two teams, Shane. I think East defence has been terrific and North is a bit too loose.
Or should it will. It'll take this free kick in the back pocket. And umpire a little reluctant at the moment to be giving any free kicks, especially in front of goal. Defence or forward. East, the handball on. Jax it was. Now just scoops it up off the ground. Has players there, but they can't capitalise. Over the top was Odgers. The handball came out. North put a foot to it. And it's very, very scrappy, but the free kick will go to East Ballarat.
That's better umpiring.
Let's see who'll be the recipient. Jimmy Buckley to hand the ball back. Get it quickly. We don't get a chance to get a look, but a shocking kick. If he had to pick out anyone, it should have been a teammate. And there was one North Ballarat player there who took it back into defence, and it's the same thing's happened again. Number 49 is Haseloff. Drives it. Oh, good grab, but I reckon the free kick should nearly go to Northway. Was nudged down. Now he's going to pay the mark. Could have gone either way. East Ballarat. Play becomes a bit stagnant. They push it to that far side of the ground. The big arms of Ford go up. Is he going to be paid the mark? Yes. And Alister Ford will take the grab.
Certainly covering some ground, Alister Ford. You can see him kicking goals, and he's also taking a lot of marks in their back line.
Two on one. This spells danger. I've noticed North, they're defending a little bit better. Whoa! I've said too much too early. Here they go. They set up the running players. The loose player, the whistle's on play, and I reckon it's going to go the opposite way. Now, you guys had your eye on the play further back there. I was following the flight of the ball.
No, there was an infringement there, Rob. I couldn't really see what it was, but there was an infringement there.
I think Michael Troon might have been the offender. A crucial turnover, Ian, because...
Well, look at the short here.
Yes, Smokey Dawson again.
Dawson it is who takes the grab. Now, he's got two.
Now, just come back to that, Rob. It was a crucial turnover because North were on their way. They'd reached the centre, and now East are having a shot for goal.
Just a couple of times in the last 5 minutes, I've noticed North run the ball out of that defending line a lot easier, and they're starting to set up play. Players making position further up the ground.
North, I think, Rob, North's biggest problem is they're playing from behind, and they're just giving far too many free kicks away.
Dawson's kick on its way. This looks all right. Has it carried?
And two goals is the lead for East Ballarat on the Gillies Pies scoreboard. And they've worked it out of the centre again. I'll be looking down here for Whyte, who's got too much pace that time for Chaos Ryan, who's on the ground from the bench. Gets the lead from Dawson. Out come the North defenders. That's better. That's what they've got to do, says Ian Baker. And they did it nicely that time as they drive out of defence down toward the centre. Well done, Simpson. He's got Buckley on his hammer. He kicks off the ground toward the safety of the boundary. But they've got red, white and blue jumpers in numbers here. And it was fortunate that Ross McEnany came across and gave some assistance. Well done. He finds Orr down that far side of the ground. And in fact, will it be carried over the boundary line? Just was. James O'Connell just couldn't keep it in play.
Interesting to note before when Alan Besley was talking about Jim Buckley saying to the guys, forget about the 49 games we've won straight. To come into a grand final like this, Ian Baker, how much more pressure's on you?
Well, it's an enormous pressure. I think, Rob, it really starts to work hard on your emotions, and this is what's happening here at the moment, I think.
Jim Buckley, the man we're talking about, gets the ball from centre-half back, drives it in towards the centre of the ground, just inside 50. We're off for a run again. This is Evans. Gets the handball to no one in particular. They have the numbers here. Troon spins into trouble and's collared. Good tackle.
That is what you call the perfect tackle.
Desperation from Scott O'Donohue. And O'Donohue, unfortunately, the good work undone. Putting players under pressure up the ground. The handball's on. Big Ford scoops on it. Handball's out wide. The running player here, Jax, has a chance. He puts the head down and goes for home. Now it's got a push in the back for mine too. Umpire, will he go back or is he going to play it further down the ground? Because the lead's on down here. And everyone stood and let Paul Whyte in. Whyte from inside 50.
Another one.
Unfortunately, that was bad umpiring because really he had stopped the play and he's just let him play on after a couple of seconds break, which makes it very difficult.
And Ian, it was also very questionable.
Yes.
Here's Whyte kicking the goal, by the way. It was a good goal too. He could have gone over the top to Dawson, actually. He probably was wondering that. But just coming back to the free kick, it was actually questionable whether it was down the ground in the first place at all, to be quite honest.
Correct.
So let's have a look at that Gillies Pies scoreboard. This is a great start for East. Reminiscent of Ballarat's start in 88, 6-2, sorry Ian to say that, 6-2-38 that should be, to 3-2-20, as Ford gets the tap down. Actually to his opposition, Ruckman Brown, and Ford taps it again. But now North, able to get that critical first possession out of the centre. Johnny Orr gave a nice little shove, but well-read Evans at the back. His disposal's been poor, his getting of the footy has been terrific. Comment Ian Baker.
Yes, he has for sure, and I think Tony Evans has been really holding East backline here, and again, he's been a part of it again.
That might be young Troon again, off half-back, looking for Hills. Up goes Big Ford, getting back well to provide the numbers across that half-back line. Ball hits the ground, well done Hills. Hand passes across to Quinlan, and downfield he's been decked, and Seeley will be having a shot from 15 metres out.
Yes, just a little bit of an indiscriminate tackle from Terry Simpson then, and ball's relayed down.
What was that word you used then, Bakes?
Indiscriminate.
Oh, right. Okay.
It's a great word to use, too, after you've had a couple of quiet scotches to calm the nerves. He should kick this, Seeley. Everyone tells me he's a pretty talented footballer. Kicked 100 this year. He's got two, and he's only 15 metres out.
Seeley will come in.
shouldn't miss from here. And the Roosters answer very, very quickly. That's their fourth. They move to 4-2. The Bulldogs, 6-2.
I think, Shane, you'd like probably playing in North Ballarat in the full forward position too, because you get a fair bit of the ball.
I tell you what, they deliver it superbly, don't they? And, I mean, that time was a gimme goal. But just looking at the big bloke, Ian, he's a nice strap of a guy, isn't he? 24 years of age, should have plenty of good footy ahead of him.
He's certainly come on this year. He got a fair few senior games last year, but this year he's really cemented his spot. Certainly with 111 goals, you're not...
Something North never lack, and they always seem to be able to produce full forwards.
Yes, well, we have. That was one point that really they've worked hard on.
Back into the centre of the ground. One prodigy, I suppose they can put claim to. They're very proud of, is one T. Lockett. This is Buckley. Buckley from out of the centre. A wobbly old kick, but they have control of it. The handball's on. The chance here for Lewis. Lewis inside 50, and they've answered it quickly. That's their fifth.
No.
No offline. Oh, that goal umpire's got me.
That's actually too bad, Mrs. to Lewis. He hasn't had the sort of first quarter he would have liked, Rob and Ian.
No, he usually stitches those goals up.
Wes Lewis, offline. A let-off for the Bulldogs. Ashley Cook it is that brings it into play, and over the line and out of bounds. Scoreboard side or highway side. Yes, we were talking about full forwards. I mean, we can look back. We've got the Howards. We had the Ken Murrays.
Yes, Malcolm Scott's.
Oh, yeah, wasn't he a good player?
Yeah.
Let's not reminisce. Let's get on with the footy. We'll reminisce after the game, I'm sure. East Ballarat, Odgers. Back towards the centre, or centre wing, to the ground. Plenty of weight being used, but it's going to be over the line out of bounds. This is Troon forcing it over.
He's had a good quarter, Rob.
And Wolak putting plenty of pressure on him. I've been very impressed with Evans, as you said, though, Shane. His disposal's probably let him down a little bit. By gee, he's had some possessions.
Here's the throw-in. Big Brown. Thump further afield, good play. Down, in fact, beyond the centre now. Can North make something of this? We're 5 minutes into time on. We've had 10 goals kicked in the quarter, so we'd reckon we might even have another minute or so before the first quarter ends. And that famous red time that you often talk to me about, Rob, it's very important now that East can hold on with this two-goal break, because it has been their quarter. They wouldn't want to concede another one now. It's actually Wolak got that tap down.
The toughest time of footy, red time, believe you me. This is O'Connell, it is. Drives it out. Now can they capitalise? Can they get a goal before that quarter time sign? I don't think they will. It might beat them. North Ballarat have numbers over the top of the ball. Gee, the umpire let that go on for a while. Good mark. Great mark for the Roosters. And this is Brett Quinlan. Spins quickly. Looking for a player further up the ground. He's got one. No, through the hands. East have got the numbers there. In fact, the nudge. Oh, a little bit ticky touchwood. Into his back. The umpire's closer than what we are.
I reckon Hill should have marked that, Ian.
Blooded,
yeah,
will be.
Philly hard mark.
Whoa, it was danger. Blood's little kick. Gee, from the back line, you should be pushing those long. This is Haseloff. The handball's on. Across here to O'Donohue. They give me heart failure a little bit, East. They're prepared to play it short out of the back line. Back here to O'Donohue. It's worked for them. Who's there? Number 23.
Well, Gladman.
It is Gladman. And Gladman... If I were the East coach, I'd be running over saying, listen, just take your time here, boy. If we could capture this one just inside the siren, well, what a great kick. I think it's going to fall short, though. Long arms go up, nobody home. Forced through, yes! Goal off the back of the pack. Has it come from Ford? Don't tell me he's roved this again. Surely not.
I think that's what we were saying there before, Shane.
He's
doing an enormous amount of work on the ground here at the moment. He's actually setting himself up for marks in the forward line, but he's not letting himself down, but he is going into their back line also.
Oh, superb football by Alister Ford. You saw it there on screen on the replay. Missed the mark, kept his eyes for the ball, was lucky it bounced back up into his chest. And who would have thought that Alister Ford would have two to his credit in this first quarter? Well, Dawson with three. He's the focal point down there.
Well, you say you're lucky that it bounced back into his arms, Robin. You're quite right. But as Ian points out, he's making himself get down into that goal square. And gee whiz, what an impact he's having as he gets another tap down. And O'Connell, the vice-captain, forces it further forward. Taken here for the Roosters by Hines. Down beyond attacking 50. Again, three red, white and blue jumpers get there first. And there's the siren for quarter time. As Sean Blood just gets a nice little kick off the ground for a stat. And it's 7-2-44 to 4-3-27, East in front.
And we'll take a break. Back with highlights of this first quarter.
They're talking to his boys at the moment, and I'd say he would have plenty to say. But then again, it's only the first quarter of football in a grand final, and a lot can happen. But a 17-point break to East Ballarat at the first quarter, Ian Baker, would you have thought that would have happened?
Oh, well, I did say at the start that I think that East would start better than North, which has happened. And East certainly was kicking into a breeze, which is another positive sign in regard to their situation. You know, I think really they're going to have to work very hard now, North, and I think there's a lot to be done.
Well, that was the first goal, Wolak, very early in the match, and then that terrific mark by Dawson, and he put it through, and they had two in 2 minutes, and I mean, that is the dream start.
Well, I mean, the lifter really later on, Shane, as we see a goal coming back here to North Ballarat in a moment. The defence of East has worked terribly well, but there's a bouncing ball going through. I think that came off the boot there of Andrew Ford, actually. But this goal back here of that one of Dawson's, where he's jagged it around with a banana kick, that was a bottler. Now, that could lift anyone, but they've played desperate football. Ford, been a great contributor all over the ground. The big ruckman has got two goals to his credit, but he's quite prepared to follow the ball into the back line, into the forward line, and cover plenty of ground.
At the other end of the ground, we're seeing Seeley there kick one of his three goals of the quarter. But I've got to say, Ian, that East has looked the more positive at both ends of the ground.
For sure. I think really it's been set up by Alister Ford. I think North really needs to probably put Chris Hills into the ruck.
Well, Alan Besley downstairs. I know he's been having one ear to the North Ballarat coach, Jim Buckley. What's he had to say, Alan?
Well, the situation with North Ballarat, they're being led to the ball, according to their coach, Jim Buckley. He wants them to push their bodies a lot harder. Push, push, push was the appeal to each of his players. He's very critical of the kicking of Wes Lewis in that quarter, who'd missed two very, very easy goals. And this quarter, be direct.
Well, they are the words from Jim Buckley, and I think we've pretty well summed that up, gentlemen. Wes Lewis probably should have got those two. And as we said before, 17 points to margin, and they were easy goals missed from inside 15 metres. Now, John Dunn, I know he's been to the other side of the ledger. I don't think it would be a very pumped-up Gary Odgers. I think he'd be looking for a cool head, but the same desperation, Dunny. What's he had to say?
He certainly is, Rob. He told his players, forget about that first quarter. It's one quarter at a time. He particularly singled out Alister Ford and also Terry Simpson for their great work in that first quarter. And he said, let's stick to our game plan, and that is to run, and run those North Ballarat players off the legs, Rob.
Thank you very much, John Dunn, with those comments down on the boundary line. Well, our commentary team summed it up pretty well. Let's have a look at some of the stats at the moment, and we see East Ballarat with 60 kicks to 43, and I think that probably tells the story. The handball's 25 to 18, and the freeze pretty well even. But
Rob, I mentioned Peter O'Connell in that first quarter, and 8 kicks and 2 handballs tells the story. Scotty O'Donohue, 4 kicks and 5 handballs. So both double-figure possession getters in that opening stanza. Wayne Dawson did well up on the forward line. Paull Whyte had his share of touches. So did Tony Evans on that half-back line. Bakes on the other side of the ledger for your North Ballarat team. The captain coach probably had more touches than anybody else.
Yes, but still the overall match statistics for him are down, and that's where it's showing on the scoreboard.
Well, they've got the breeze in the second quarter, and here's Jax bursting out of the centre. Should kick long. That's what he's done. This might bounce through, but it's offline. Tell you what, that's the way home down here at the Archer Victory end of the City Oval. With this breeze blowing, it is to kick long. Well done to Caius Ryan for anticipating the long kick. He was chasing back, but he wouldn't have got there. So it's an even 3-goal lead to the Bulldogs from the kick out. Ball brought to the ground. Plenty of red, white and blue Guernseys in there again. Here comes Little Orchard. He's on his way. And it's home. It's home. And Orchard has kicked his first of the day. And the signs are there very, very early that the Bulldogs can absolutely pull up a fantastic turn up here. It is early, early days, but they are 4 goals to the good with a whole quarter of wind-assisted time at their back. I tell you what, North has got to dig deep right now, Bakes.
For sure. I think really they're just so positive at the moment, and why shouldn't they be looking at the scoreboard? And I think they're playing with enthusiasm, and by gee, North's going to take a lot of turning that around.
Back into the centre again. The big thump out comes this way. This time it goes to McInerney. McInerney towards Buckley. Buckley couldn't get a fist to it cleanly. Trapped by Troon. Spins into trouble though. Orchard over the ball. Desperation. And the umpire will put a whistle on play, and we'll see it go into the turf again. And the umpire just having a few words to say to a couple of the boys off the fall of the ball. And they're very cautiously looking around him. I'd love to know what's being said out there. Big forward it is. Gets the tap out. Collared by North, back again by East. Scrambling play, pushing the back, and the free kick will go to East Ballarat. Now, who'll take it? The captain? No,
Terry Simpson, I think it is.
Simpson, right. It is. Simpson, number 11, will drive it up towards, oh, right on 50. It's a good kick from Simpson and the mark at the back. Whoa, and a 50 metres, thank you. It's got to be. Surely that would have to be 50.
Yes.
Gladman took the mark and just undisciplined football.
Paul Kennedy grabbed him a bit late, threw him back.
For one fleeting moment, I didn't think he was going to give 50. And I thought I might have to turn around and put on a white uniform. Here it is on replay. Fairly blatant.
Oh, no doubt. And I'll tell you what, that has made it a six-goal lead. Now that, let's just check it, a five-goal lead. 9-3-57 on the Gillies Pies scoreboard to 4-3-27. That's 3 minutes into the second quarter. And a few signs that North might be a little bit rattled.
Yeah, well, they've tried to cover Alister Ford. They've brought Nick Whyte in off the bench, big boy. So, you know, I still believe that they really need to put Chris Hills in there because Chris is going to be that just a little bit more experience against Alister.
Those words coming from the ex-North Ballarat coach. And he knows these players fairly well. Back into the centre. Ford going up here against Whyte. Got a bit more height and a bit more weight about him, Nick Whyte. And the pass has come off here and it goes down towards their forward zone to Orr. Been busy early. Orr, a little kick, looks for the shorts. Behind, good grab, no. Yes, it is. Been paid. They're a long, long way away from us. That's Haseloff. And Haseloff looking to offload with a handball. Could hear someone calling for it. Go back and take your kick, son. Far side. They have the numbers at the back north. Can they capitalise? They do. This is Cushion. And Cushion's kicks high. Doesn't cover a lot of territory. Covers more up than down. It'll bring rain, but we don't want it. It's a beautiful setup we've got here at the City Oval this afternoon. Conditions perfect. A little bit of wind going towards the Arch of Victory end. As the umpire brings it back into play again. Buckley at the back looking for the crumbs. Three on one. And it's going to be forced over the line and out of bounds. I said three on one, it was two on two, but there was another Bulldog jumper just lurking at the side. They've got numbers at the fall of the ball, Shane Healy.
Yeah, we've seen that over and over and over again, aren't we? Robbie, as this bounce comes, that was a pretty healthy leap too from Marcus Wolak. But a good tap on might bring Jimmy Buckley into the game here. What's the... Just decides to chip short. And Easter working out of defence most impressively. The captain coach, Gary Odgers. Handballs off and here they come again along that far side of the ground, along the southern wing. Trying to hold them up here are the Roosters defenders. Hand pass came across from Kennedy in the direction of Wes Lewis, who should get a free here. And in that centre duel, Wes Lewis lowered his colours to Peter O'Connell in the first quarter.
And he's been shifted to a half-forward flank too, I think, Shane.
Thanks, Bakes, as he kicks on left foot. Wolak goes up. Who waits down? A black and white jumper was down in Chris Hills. A little bit slow getting over the top of the footy. The East defenders tied up. And we're going to get a ball up right on North's attacking 50. With East in front of the Ballarat Football League Grand Final of 1993 by five goals. 9-3-57 to 4-3-27. And we're 7 minutes into the second quarter.
At the moment, North Ballarat desperately trying to get a goal on the board. That time off the boot of Quinlan. It's a dribbly old one. Down in towards the forward zone. Over the top of the ball is that Buckley. Desperately trying. Can't get it out. Haseloff over there for East Ballarat. And it's still in play as they work it through from behind. They do. And it's forced through. So desperate football. This is grand final football at its best. Desperation, the underdogs with a sniff and their nose in front. And I don't mean that to be a play on words, being the Bulldogs with their nose in front. A chance trapped off the top of the pack. Lewis, as he lifted his game, drives in towards the forward zone. Underneath it. Oh, handball, that's a throw. Umpire says no, play on. How you can handball it one-handed with the other hand held, I don't know.
Good point.
But he's put a whistle on play and we'll see it go into the turf.
And look who's at the bottom again. Number 43 of East, Little Orchard. He is really a true rover, real burrower.
And the ball's only 25 metres out from North's goal. Off hands, quick. Orr, can he capitalise? It looks all right. Johnny Orr gets a belated goal for the Roosters.
Mark Orchard certainly doing well there, Shane, too.
So East forcing it forward with the breeze from the ball up. Down toward half-forward flank. Here in front of the grandstand, in front of our commentary position. And it's been forced over for a throw-in.
Would love them to stay this side of the ground all day, I can tell you.
Well, it's a big, big ground.
Well, there's 2.5 acres between and the other, here and the other wing.
We're a long way across, but of course we've got the assistance of the TV monitors, and here's the throw-in now, and it's going to be an East free kick. It's big Alister Ford. He's outside 50, gets the lead. Oh, it's a lovely pass.
That was a delight to watch. And it's a very, very good mark.
I'd class that as a 9-iron, right beside the pin.
I tell you what, yes, it was perfect.
Oh, beautiful weight.
Matt Stevens, I don't think, had his hand on the ball too much at all in the first quarter. Just two kicks and one handball. He's not your robust bullocking full forward, but he let out nicely there in front of Kennedy. And this is an important one for East to hold that five-goal buffer. And it's home. Yes. Oh, he kicked that delightfully, Stevens.
Again, we had Alister Ford in the play again. See where he positioned himself right down in the goal square. He's playing very well, and I think you can just see the work that he's doing up and down the ground.
Fairly good matchup though, Ian, with having a look at Kennedy. They're both fairly evenly matched in size and height and weight.
To Matty Stevens, yes, for sure. Rob, Kanga's probably coming back after a serious sort of shoulder injury. I don't know how sort of fit he is, but he certainly is out there, so he's got to be fit.
Back to the centre. Ford, it is doing the ruck work. Gives a big nudge there to Nick Whyte. Whyte got underneath it. There's a chance for the Bulldogs to go forward again. This time it looked like it could have been who I've missed, but I know who this fella is. Dawson wants to get going quickly, and this could bounce through. No, it won't. Takes a leg break.
The pass came from
the opposite way.
Pass came from Wolak, Robbie.
Wolak, was it?
Having a pretty good game too, Wolak.
Been very busy early on that far side of the ground. Now, of course, with the change of quarter, he will be down on grandstand side. I thought for one fleeting moment we were going to see a repeat of North's earlier goal where the ball just kept bouncing and bouncing. But we didn't see such. Play underway again. North, Whyte, fresh player on the ground. Repelling kick there from East Ballarat was blocked, and players throw themselves over the top of the ball. Little player there, Matthew Cox it was, who was putting the hand up towards the umpires to say, hang on, here's making no attempt to get rid of it.
Interesting change at East there, Ian.
Yeah, so just taking Alister Ford down to full forward, and they've put Matt Stevens into the ruck, I suppose, just to give Alister a bit of a spell here, but still, they're actually attacking here, and he'd be a great beacon here at the moment.
Whyte gets it out of that melee there, but it's the man in front here for North Ballarat. Looks like it could have been Quinlan. Quinlan or Poppinghorn down to the far side of the ground, centre wing. A chance for them. The runner's on here now from Holloway. Gets the boot to ball. Now, one-on-one from behind. Ford couldn't do it. Chance. This is Orr at the back, is it? Handball's off on selfish football, and they'll collar this one. No, they won't offline. Hills again.
Ooh,
I won't say
misses.
Anymore.
We've had some bad misses.
I think that's number three.
Wes dropped two in the first quarter. Now Chris should have stitched that one up also.
So three bad misses for the Roosters from inside 20 metres should not happen in grand finals. But there is a fair amount of pressure. They're looking for their 50th. They're looking for their third grand final in a row. And at the moment, the Bulldogs are serving everything up to them. Doing it well. From half back to centre wing. Gary Odgers outnumbered on that occasion. And the numbers there for North Ballarat. And this is McInerney. In towards the centre, diving mark. No, bump ball, the umpire said. Couldn't make up his mind. He's paid the mark now. And it looked like it's Evans, is it? What's the other way doing away down there? Evans. Wobbly old kick here towards the halfback line. It may go over the line. No, it's just kept in. Quick kick by Berry. Now, this will allow the Bulldogs to come through. O'Connell into the centre. Good grab. Odgers sets it up. Two on one. Can they meet them full on? Puts the tackle on O'Donoghue. They look like they were going to break straight through centre-half forward. North doing well. They've defended well here. And they'll get a free kick out of this. A little lucky. I was just a little stagnant in my commentary there because I thought for one moment that East were just going to burst through centre-half, and they stopped and propped and paid the price. They've got a chance. He's off. Blood it was. Should have probably stopped. And the options weren't there. Cushion. Right foot. And it's going to go over the line out of bounds. It will.
Great smother. It was a terrific smother, Rob. And I reckon that's just indicative of East today. They are just absolutely desperate to get first hands on the footy every time. And it's forward of their wing position. And there's Nick Whyte going up that time against Matt Stevens, who's having a run on the ball, as Bates suggested to you earlier. East attack up towards centre half forward, but it's going to be Jason Berry to repel. So North are five goals down in the grand final, and they've got a half to play into the breeze. Berry's kick lands in the centre. Who's down? O'Connell again. Couldn't grab it that time. Terry Simpson went in hard. He couldn't take the ball out either. It's in the centre. Important ball to be won here. And it's won by East. They force it forward. Bad drop mark. Kick off the ground to Orchard. He's away, the speedster. From 50 to Ford. Oh, good footy, Orchard. You are playing a ripper game. And
Kevin Bartlett often points out to me down in Melbourne, and this is a great lesson for smaller players. And here we are, Alister Ford doing it, the consummate pro. When there's a snap kick out of a pack, position your body in front because it will invariably drop short. That's exactly what happened there. And look who's got it, the best man on the ground, Alister Ford.
Yes, Shane, I think North have really struggled in their back line. They're playing too far behind and they're paying the penalty for it. And obviously when you said there they should have been in front, it's a perfect example of it.
Well, Ford's only 30 metres out. And he's kicked well. They're doing everything right east.
Have answered the challenge. And how far have we travelled in this quarter? Some 12 minutes and nearly a six-goal lead.
Yes, they're certainly setting up a very good half-time break here. And, you know, again, North are going to come back at them. There's no doubt about that. Whether East can just keep holding, they need to just hold on and really keep the initiative up.
Well, we say they're going to come back. You say they're going to come back. But then again, if you get a break big enough, we saw Essendon be able to get back over the top of Adelaide. But you can demoralise sides. They've got the job in front of them. The Bulldogs are doing everything right. They're little players at the fall of the ball. Drive it up towards half forward again. Two grabs almost pulled in there by Gladman. Couldn't do so. They force it out wide. The running play here, Cook from inside 50. Drives it. Ford's going to let it go. It's good enough. I think that was Ashley Cook.
Yes, it was.
Well, where do we get the adjectives to describe what the Bulldogs are doing at the moment? Let's have a look at it on replay. Good hands there from Gladman. Saw Cook coming past, off balance, through, splits the woodwork, and it was Cox.
Good goal too, Robbie. Just got himself in the right spot, didn't he?
Back to the centre of the ground. Boy, am I excited with this. What a turn-up. 12-4, place 5-5 on the Gillies Pies scoreboard. Back to the centre of the ground.
Here's the bounce. Nick Whyte, first hands on the footy, down to Buckley. Tried to kick it off the ground. Cox ran it down. East Ballarat Guernsey's there first again. Cox links with Gladman. Backwards they go, but good option to Orchard. Down here looking for Dawson. He's out in front of Chaos Ryan. Gets the shove. Play on. Out comes Orchard again. Down in the direction here of Stevens. Good spoil, Kennedy. And it's over the boundary line for a throw-in. They are first to the footy just about every time, East.
I think they're just running in numbers, Shane. I think every time you see a contest, they're outmanning North all the time. And I think it's just their enthusiasm.
I'll get you to keep an eye on Kennedy. I think he's injured.
Here's the throw-in. It's tapped toward the goal square. Dawson and Chaos Ryan go at it, and Kennedy carries it through. So there's a shot of Kennedy now. Rob, perhaps feeling he might have hurt an arm there or a wrist. And we're going to see Chris Hills now. He's back, either having a run on the ball or in defence. We'll get Bakes to keep an eye on that as Chris Hills kicks out. Out to defensive 50. Here's Jason Berry. Gets the handball going toward Troon. On the ground, he goes inside. Good play, Lewis. Now, the umpires said there was a throw there. So nothing going right for North.
I think what's happening is why Chris Hills has been put back to full back. Alister Ford's actually taking the ruck work in the centre and then dropping down to full forward.
So East are going to come forward again. They're seven goals up. And there's a good mark here in defence, taken by Michael Hines. Hines will chip short to defensive 50. Got a teammate out there on half-back flank. And that's Craig Cushion. So he'll kick along that highway side of the ground, looking for Lewis, having a better quarter. He's away. Links up with Johnny Orr, who's had a pretty good game. Just handballs out in front of himself there, then kicks off the ground. Not bad play. Oh, there's a great diving effort. That is Evans. Tony Evans having a marvellous game. And he's just working the ball out to Wolak. He's on that highway wing. He's got Andrew Ford to beat. Scrimmage. Nice tackle there by Orchard. He's in everything, Orchard. He is really having a dip, like a good old-fashioned roader. Got the long sleeves on. Burrowing down there into the green grass, and there's just a patch of mud over here on the main grandstand side, and so we've got a throw in, and East with plenty of time to try and work the ball away. This time the boundary line will beat all players. Good shot of the thick crowd there at the back. There's plenty of them here at the City Oval. They are watching one of the big turn-ups in recent years in country footy, with East leading by seven goals exactly halfway through the second quarter.
Kennedy up towards centre wing there, doing a little bit of the ruck work. But his opposition number, not so much number, but Ruckman in forward. Gee, he's causing havoc at the moment for the North Ballarat side. Puts the ball down to the ground here. Oh, I just put the foot in there and caused the trip, I think. And the free kick will go North Ballarat's way. Yes, it will. And far side of the ground. Highway wing, and the player here is Troon. I want you to keep an eye on Jimmy Buckley. He's looks like a walking wounded for me, Ian Baker. I'll get to you very shortly. A chance. Players throw themselves over the top of the ball. The loose ball comes out to North. They drive it. Here's Orr on his own in front. Is it going to bounce too high? Orr tackled without it. Let play. Very, very lucky. And plenty of pressure being utilised. Back into the centre, and they're going to capitalise here, North. A little bit lucky. I think they probably should have got the free kick a bit earlier. But we'll see where the umpire's going to line Seeley up here. Yes, it is. Dean Seeley with three to his credit so far should kick this one. Let's go back and see how Jim Buckley is in the centre of the ground.
Yeah, I think Jimmy's got a bit of a problem with his knee there. He's certainly really struggling at the moment. He's limping around, so don't be surprised if he doesn't come off.
Seeley shouldn't miss and doesn't. So North Ballarat get a badly needed goal. They'll move on to 6-7 place, 41 on the Gillies Pie scoreboard. And the umpire's letting play go. And there's a couple down here having a little bit of a dance and a how do you do with the emergency umpire. Just there, Johnny, on the spot. A good umpire because they're letting play go on. They'll break it up themselves. East, a chance, centre wing. Grandstand side. The pass is good to Whyte. Whyte quickly wants to get it moving because he knew that there should have been one less North Ballarat player up there in the tussle. But they've repelled well. Easy. Pool of Holloway it was. Actually got the handball off. Puts his teammate under pressure. Big Nick Whyte. Not quick. Here's Buckley. Let's see how he moves here now. No, that's not the Buckley of old. JB would have been over that like a hot scone. Onto the ground. The umpire will put a whistle on play. Dropping the ball, he says. And the free kick will go North Ballarat's way. Taking the kick here is Pogginghorn. This is Travis. Into the centre of the ground. Good match up there. Troon for North Ballarat got underneath the flight of the ball. And things just starting to go North Ballarat's way now. The old adage of football, get in front, get in underneath, and you should cop it all from the umpire. Troon it is. Drives it right to the edge of 50. Long arms up. No, yes, he's going to pay it.
Good mark.
I thought he must have forgotten the whistle for a moment. And North Ballarat should go back, not look for the pass, and drive this long.
Might be Travis Pulkinghorn, is it, just on the ground?
No, number 21 it should be, Quinlan.
Sorry.
Quinlan, a little undecided. The lead's on. Quinlan, the kick's on its way. It's not going to make the distance. It'll fall 15 metres out and it's on again up the other end of the ground. But we'll watch the play here. Buckley in over the top of the ball. And East. Players down there, to me, a little bewildered at the moment. I don't think they know what's going on because the ball's going to beat Orchard over the line out of bounds. And there's some 20, 30 or 20 players and a little bit of a melee up the other end of the ground.
It's more than just a little bit of a melee. Ford, Dawson have been going at it. That they're on the same team. Against their opponents for a good minute, Rob.
Play underway again. You keep your eye there on ringside. I'll keep my eye on the footy down here. And East Ballarat turn around and break away. Ball slipped at the crucial stage. Good football, though. That was Simpson breaking away and getting it up to the other side of the ground. And a good mark taken here. Far side. This is O'Connell. The handball's on. They've got a chance to set something up here now. It won't bounce up, though. This is Evans. Cleverly dodges around. Finds a teammate. They drive it in towards centre-half forward. What can happen here? They've got the run. They're in front. Pushed off the ball. Good defensive work done by North. The handball's on, but the pressure's by East. Unfortunately, Holloway couldn't get away. The loose player being set up. Bit of speed. A chance here. The handball. A wobbly old one from Jax. Finds its mark. Looks across here for Odgers. Odgers blazes, and it's good. That's good enough. Gary Odgers, a great captain coach's goal. Well, you guys kept your eye at one end of the ground on TV ringside. I kept my eyes on the football. And as they work the ball from the other end, let's have a look at Odgers here. And good shepherding in there by Smokey Dawson. Lets it through.
Yes, I think East have certainly got the initiative rolling here, and they're playing very, very good football. North's going to find it very hard to sort of peg it back.
Now, the runner's out here. And I don't think I have to tell you. You saw it for yourself. The runner came out, spoke to Dawson. And Dawson's charged back at the opponent. So I think something off the ball's happened that's really fired up Smokey.
Yeah, Dawson and Hills have been going at it for a couple of minutes down there. And tell you what, I think on a points decision, you give it to Dawson all round because East actually got a goal in the middle of it all. So it's back in the centre. Buckley there in the front of your screen. Good tap down, big Nick Whyte. And North is going to try and answer that goal, which was a real lifter for East against the run of play. North had been attacking. Well taken, Gladman. And passes across to a busy Whyte, up to his captain coach, Odgers. Just couldn't take it cleanly. Well done, Troon, but was tackled. It's on the half-forward line here. Eastern attack. Nice hand pass, McInerney. Out into the open to War, who got a bad bounce. He was well chased by O'Donoghue. The tackling of East has been terrific. But North hold possession here. That was well played. Hand pass came across from Hines toward Grant Poltinghorn, up toward the centre. Here's Little Orchard again. Love to see his stats. And he does something with the footy every time. And just chips it around the corner to Scott O'Donoghue. O'Donoghue, a busy player, has got it on the highway wing. Drives down to attacking 50. Oh, Stevens. Nice grab, Matt Stevens. Plays on quickly. He's got Dawson back here. Dawson fell over. And Chaos Ryan wins the battle this time. And no surprise that Dawson gives away 50. Because if there's some hot blood anywhere in Australia at the moment,
it'll go the other way.
It's been taken off, Ryan, has it? Let's know it hasn't.
Oh.
What I think he did, I think he might have taken the 50-metre penalty off him and let him keep the... I can't read anything else into that. That was a strange one.
This one's what you call a mark.
Well, Ryan's picked out Stevens again. So Stevens will come along, and this time Alister Ford is waiting back in the square. Good picture there of young Stevens, waiting for Ford to move. Ford saying, put it high. Oh, bad option. He went across to O'Connell, who had it stolen. Free kick to North. They should have gone long there. They had Big Ford waiting in the square. Now Orr links up here with Cushion. And Cushion traverses the square up to centre half forward, over the shoulder surely. It'll be against Travis Polkinghorne. And a free kick to East. And they are defending terrifically.
Doing it exceptionally well. They bring it out to the wing. This is Evans. Grandstand side. Took off before acceptances, but had enough time to come back. Measured the kick well into the centre. Now they're just looking for the gaps and they're finding them at the moment. Wolak. Marcus Wolak takes the mark. A little bit forward of centre wing. The lead's on. In front. Two hands out in front. Nearly pulled it in, Gladman. Spins around. Puts it up high. Travel the distance. Can someone bring it down? No, they can't. Over the top. Weight being used. The handball's not on. North will come away. Plenty of pressure. Only one way for them to go, and that's head for the boundary line.
I think, Rob, they're certainly, East are playing to their size capabilities. They're chipping the ball. They're kicking to the front of the packs, and they're just running onto the ball. I think if they try to beat North in the air, they knew that they were going to have problems, and they've certainly played to their good game plan.
Oh, just trying to take it out of the air. Now the free kick will go to East Ballarat, and it'll go to Odgers. I didn't see that. I saw him come to the ground. He tried to take it out of the air of the ruck, and he's about 6 or 8 inches shorter than perhaps his opposition number. Drives it in. Nobody home. It's going to go off the boot of Ford and over the line and out of bounds. I'm going to keep my eye on Smokey Dawson. You can keep your eye on the football for a moment because I reckon it's about to erupt again.
Yes, it's. Well, he's had a real influence, Dawson, because what's he kicked? 3 goals. He's set up a couple of others. He's unsettled Hills. He's unsettled everybody. He's fired the commentators up here as the throw-in comes down, and Ford actually missed the tap out and it just almost fell into North's arms there, and Cushion now will try and work it to the boundary. In fact, I called a Cushion. It was actually Brett Quinlan. Cushion was there to assist, and it's over for a throw-in. Good shot of the boundary umpire here as he'll fling it back now into the arena of the action. We're 24 minutes into the second quarter. East leads by 7 goals in a real turner. Quinlan hand passes to Buckley. Takes it cleverly. Might have tapped it on. Didn't. Then held the ball in the mud patch. That's one of the few patches of the ground that aren't just impeccable here. It's been a very wet winter all over Victoria. Ballarat's been no different. He's pulled out a free kick. Going to go to Odgers. Odgers was doing limbering up exercises with Gladman before the game. I'll tell you about that in a moment as he gets the lead from the big man, Ford. Oh, terrific pass.
Now, there was no way that he was going to get to that ball. He just saw the ball falling short and just dug in, Alister Ford. Desperation.
Certainly, he's playing inspired football. You can see the reason why they're dropping him down into this line, because North's strengths in their back line is their height. They can cut people to pieces with just taking those telling marks. And they've got Alister back here at the moment, just taking those marks, but he's not taking them in the air. He's taking him on the lead. And this is certainly would have to be encouraging to Gary Odgers.
Well, I just talking about Odgers, I was saying a moment ago, he was limbering up with Gladman doing their exercises, and he said to Gladman, there's 20 black and white so-and-sos that stand between us and glory, Gladdy. And at the moment, the glory might be coming the Bulldogs' way. Ford ran very close to the man on the mark, but he's put it through! And Haynes controlling proceedings. East, absolutely dominant so far in the first half of this grand final. 2 minutes off half-time, the Bulldogs lead the Roosters by 8 goals. Cox tries to force it to the front of the square, can't do so. They are just rugby-style forcing it forward east. It's taken now by Troon. He goes wide looking for Quinlan, Cushion out there helping. A North will attack now along the highway wing. Right foot kick by Quinlan, got a war.
Orr's been a pretty good player today, and he's marked forward of centre wing, and he'll send the Roosters into attack.
Johnny Orr being hotly pressured by Tony Evans. The good thing about East is that even though they are behind, if they're not there to take the mark, Evans was desperate enough to turn around and put him into the ground and keep him there. Not let them get up and get their running game going that they're famous for. Under a bit of pressure here, it was into his back, gave him no access. And the umpires paid the free kick to East Ballarat. There's the siren to half-time in what we might term, gentlemen, as a bit of a surprise and a real turn-up. So far, the Bulldogs have blown the Roosters off their perch. Let's have a look. 14-15, play 6-5. We'll be back with you shortly. Country today, believe you me, here at the City Oval of Ballarat, the 1993 Grand Final. And I say and, if we talked about a lead, gentlemen, of 48 points to East Ballarat at the start of the game. Shane Healy's eyes basically hit the ceiling, and Ian Baker believes that North are going to fight back. At the moment, I reckon you might have jumped on the right horse, Shane.
Well, I'll tell you what, I've backed naturalism in Melbourne, Rob, and I've backed East Ballarat here, and I might be heading for a daily double. But look, North is too good a side, obviously, not to come back. Just the odd time in that quarter, I just wondered if they weren't playing like a bedraggled rabble. There's a critical 50 metres, what I'm talking about, Kennedy against Gladman. And what a great grab that was by Haseloff. I mean, these are some of the younger guys at East that we don't know so much about, and they're all lifting. Johnny Orr kicked a very important goal late in the quarter.
Well, Ian, you mentioned before, a lot of the players here you don't know, and you've only been out of the North Ballarat scene for probably 3 or 4 years.
Yeah, so that's just one of their very good strengths, that they bring up their juniors very well, but by God, East playing very well, and, I say that they'll fight back, but, you know, how far they can fight back, I just don't know, because East playing inspired football at the moment.
Well, the surprise packet, Alister Ford, doesn't matter what he does, wherever he goes on the ground, this little fellow here's been doing a lot of work too. Cox and Orchard. Orchard, probably the best small man on the ground. His kicks, as I said before, in a jocular fashion, they're only 9 irons, but they're finding the spot. They're right beside the pin, they are, and doing exceptionally well. But Ford has been doing exceptionally well.
That's Seeley kicking one of his 4 goals. And I wanted just to mention the pass across from Grant Polkinghorne on that occasion to Seeley. We didn't mention it in the call. It was a terrific option, because he could have gone for goal and blazed, but he picked the better option. And again, this is a terrific goal, because East worked it and worked it. Rather than having the shot the first time, they left it for the captain coach, and he put it right through the centre. Again, some good shepherding down in the goal square. That goal came just after a lot of hoppo-bumpo between Dawson and also Chris Hills. His Ford kicking one of his 4 goals. He's given them options everywhere, including Ian and Rob right in front.
Yes, certainly they've tried to cover up their sort of deficit in their forward line. They just can't take a grab there. That was one of their real difficulties they had in the second semi-final. But now they've got Ford changing. After he takes the ruck work in the centre, he changes back into the full forward position. So, you know, he's working very well.
Well, the stats show the kicks well and truly East Ballarat's way. A margin of 27 in a grand final. A big margin. The mark's 40-22. Everywhere on the stat sheet, they're just about in front. Handball's pretty well even, as we can see there in front. But there's something that stands out, Ian Baker. The tackles,
yeah.
12-4. Their desperation is much, much better. They're winning in the ruck, and the freeze for 19-9. It's the old story. In front, you should get everything from the umpire.
I think we said it at the start of the game. I think that, you know, and, you know, just a report that came out of the rooms where Reese was so fired up. It just, you know, they really wanted to desperate, and I, you know, the start of the next half is certainly something that's going to sort of give us a fair indication of what's going to carry on from there.
Well, our camera crew, SCN TV, the boys up there probably doing a little cool here in Ballarat this afternoon. On ground level, I can tell you it is lovely, but the boys up there doing a great job. And we've just had a footballer's relay race and foot race underway here at the moment. But the Ballarat Football League, as is every country football league, have their best and fairest. We see some great champions emerge. We see some players go on to AFL level. But this year, let's just find out what happened in the Henderson Medal here for 1993 in the Ballarat Football League.
About 300 people attended the Henderson Medal vote count in Ballarat. The early favourites were East's Alister Ford, Redan's Michael Smith, and North Ballarat's Wes Lewis. As the vote count progressed, the early leaders were Alister Ford and Sebastopol's Barry Knight. The big crowd were kept in suspense for most of the count, with any one of three players right there till the finish.
Redan M. Smith.
There was jubilation at the Redan table as supporters congratulated 21-year-old Michael Smith, who spent 3 years with Collingwood. The Scotch College groundsman collected his prize medal from Ballarat League president Barry Fowkes. It was a popular win with the big crowd, and he paid tribute to his teammates at Redan.
I'd just like to say that, once again, it's just such an honour to win against the medal, and it's certainly been a moment I'll cherish for the rest of my life. Thank you.
Well, congratulations, and of course, the winner that year, or this year, 1993, coming from Redan.
Yes, Michael Smith had a very consistent year, was certainly one of the favourites going into the Henderson medal, and it certainly worked out that way. But, yeah, very good year from Michael.
Well, the umpires nearly gained revenge here on the City Oval just a short time ago while we were looking at the Henderson medal for 93. Umpires nearly getting up to win that footballers' relay.
I'll tell you what, it might be East Day, Rob. The East's won the footballers' relay. They've beaten the umpires, and if you can beat the umpires, you've done really well. North unplaced, and at the moment, East to the good in the grand final by 8 goals at the long break. I'm trying to think back to 88, the last time that there was a real turn-up in a Ballarat grand final when Ballarat knocked off North. And my memory is that Ballarat went out with a big lead, but by half-time, Bakes, I don't think you were 8 down. I think you were beginning to show signs by that stage of getting back into it at least.
Yes. We were at a deficit. Sorry, Rob.
Well, as we can see, our mates down there from East Ballarat, very, very happy. As Shane Healy used the racing parlance before, we're just about set for correct weight. We'll take a break and come back and have a look at the second half. The City Oval at Ballarat on grand final day. And Ballarat, of course, just some, well, a little over 100 k's from Melbourne, thereabouts, give or take a few k's.
Yes.
There's been a lot of talk throughout this year, perhaps whether Ballarat could field a team in the AFL. I have my doubts. I know you gentlemen have got plenty to say, but earlier on in the week we had a little bit of a look around the town and a chat to a few people who are actually pushing for Ballarat to have a force and a name in the AFL.
The city of Ballarat has been abuzz after the recent announcement that a local syndicate is hoping to attract an AFL club to play their home games here. A quick walk through the streets this week found that the locals are very keen on the idea.
I think it'd be terrific, providing they can get a ground suitable for them to play on.
You know, I think it'd be a jolly good idea if it worked.
Oh, well, I suppose it'd be pretty difficult, but it'd be a good idea, I think.
And one of the syndicate members is confident that the dream will become a reality.
Well, the support locally has been tremendous. Since the publicity has come out, there hasn't been one adverse comment made by either local government or by football people or by the public generally. We believe that Ballarat needs something like this to kick it along even further as a community. And I think most Ballarat people recognise that having an AFL team playing out of Ballarat would give that sort of impetus to the community.
Since the statement came out then, Peter, have you had any further talks with the AFL?
We haven't spoken with the AFL itself, and that's a deliberate strategy at this stage. We are football people and we believe we ought to talk to football clubs first and to their people first. And when the point gets reached where we're ready to talk to the AFL, then that's the time we'll talk to them. But we're in fact having discussions next week with an AFL club to further the proposal. And, you know, the gestation period might take some time, but we'll get to the AFL in due course, but we're not quite ready to talk to them yet.
And the locals of Ballarat have their own ideas on which AFL club they'd like to see relocate.
Oh, I think St Kilda would be a good team to come. They're pretty popular down here, so it'd be good, I think.
Would you change your allegiance from Essendon to perhaps Richmond or North?
You know, that might be a little bit hard for a while. I suppose I'd barrack for the local team, but except when they played Essendon, then I'd be loyal to Essendon.
And the local syndicate is quietly confident that one day there'll be an AFL club in the city of Ballarat.
We're a very strong community already in Ballarat, very sports-minded, and we think that the Ballarat community would get behind an AFL push very significantly here. And one of the things we've said we want is that support has to come from all levels of the community, and we'd like, say, 10,000 Ballarat people to become members of an AFL club that would be playing out of here, and that would probably exceed the current membership of some of the clubs we're talking to.
Interesting. Dreams, reality, call it what you like. Ex-VFL player, what are your thoughts, quickly?
Well, certainly a lot of groundwork has to be done on it, but I think some of the media coverage that we've had on it has brought a lot of good statements out, and I think that's one good thing, that people are actually talking about it. I think, you know, there is some great possibilities. You know, distance is not that far from Melbourne, but I think really we just need to have a look at the overall probably cash side of it, whether we can support it and whether the AFL can sort of go through with that.
Yeah, for sure. We see some of the AFL clubs struggling even now, but then again, with a support base around here of 90,000 people now in Ballarat, could be on. What do the people of Ballarat think?
What do you think of the idea of an AFL club coming up and playing footy here in Ballarat?
I think it's fantastic. I think it'd do wonders for Ballarat.
Which club would you like to see come and base themselves here?
Essendon. Of course, Collingwood. Collingwood. Go Pies.
What do you think about Ballarat trying to get an AFL club to come up here?
I don't think there'd be enough people to support it.
Well, yeah, I think that'd be really good. You know, bring a bit of tourism, I suppose, to Ballarat, and it'd be good to see, yeah.
Any particular club you'd like to see come in?
Probably Collingwood. And probably Collingwood would be good.
Ground level, Alan Besley's there. Jim Buckley was fairly subdued before the start of the game, Alan. I dare say it would be a change of face on the face of Jay Buckley at halftime.
He was, Roz. He accused his players of being individual, actually, during the third quarter. I'm going to put that roof back on the grandstand, and he said he's allowed East to run free in that second quarter, but he did put his players under pressure, saying we're not out of it, let's make it a 10-goal third quarter.
Well, Gary Odgers from the other side of the ledger at East Ballarat, and it was interesting to have a look at the East Ballarat rooms at the front door. You couldn't have fit a cigarette paper between the doorway and the crowd trying to get in there. Johnny Dunn, did you get in there? What did Gary Odgers have to say if you did?
Well, I certainly did, Rob. He asked his players to keep their minds focused on the football. He expects a big charge from North Ballarat in this third quarter, and he wants his players to get the ball out of the centre quickly to the flanks and wings and then attack from there. This is the quarter that will decide the cup, according to Gary Odgers.
I think you're pretty well right too, Ian Baker. Three quarter time will certainly tell the tale, but I really do believe that games of football can be won and lost actually in that third quarter.
Yes, for sure. I think, you know, I just marked down 3 points that North Ballarat have certainly 6-5-41 to East Ballarat 14-5-89. And I was just going to mention there that I think the 3 points that I wrote down out of that first half was certainly Alister Ford's domination of the game. East were more desperate, and I think also North might be playing a little bit behind, and I think I agree with Jimmy that a few of them are just not really putting enough pressure on the game.
Umpire has the ball back in the centre of the ground. Shane Healy, the start of the second half of football. Can the Roosters get back? Yes or no?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, Ian Baker's going to take sides. He's going to stick with his old team, I feel. East Ballarat trying to force it forward. This is Blood trying to kick it along the ground. Has Jim Buckley fired the boys up? Kick comes out off the hands of Lewis. This is Wes Lewis. Gets it again. Drives it back to the centre of the ground. Buckley waits at the back. Swoops on the top of it. Pushes his body over. But there's desperation by the Bulldogs. A chance again for Buckley. He's got it. That's dropping the ball, Jimbo. And the opposition coach, I think, will come out of it with a free kick at Odgers. Gary Odgers. And a good matchup, actually, the two coaches on one another at the moment. Hodges looks for the shorts. Goes to the opposite side, highway side. Doesn't gain a lot of territory, but they have a chance to open it up. This is through Jacks towards half forward. Over the back. Players, a little bit of the run would have gone out of the legs. The ground looks superb, Ian Baker, at the moment over there, but just underneath, I really feel that it would be taking a little bit out of the legs. And the side, especially when we look at one with a 48-point lead at half-time, would be the one you'd want to be on if you're having a bet.
Yes, that's right, but North haven't sort of played much football over the last month or so. You know, that sometimes makes it hard for a start, but after a while, if they can get going, get some momentum, that could come to their advantage at the end.
Shane Healy won't give in, will he?
No, he won't. He's a real rooster, and of course, this is the fifth year in a row these two sides have played in the grand final. East beat North in 89 and 90. North beat East in 91 and 92, so whose turn is it today? North forcing it forward. Down to attacking 50. They need at least that 10-goal quarter that Buckley asked for. But great mark here to East. Not being paid. Oh dear, it might go to Lewis, is it? Let's have a look who's going to get up with it over there. It's not Lewis. I'll just check it. Michael Hines, pretty quiet in the first half. Top stats getters for North in the first half were Johnny Orr, Wes Lewis, Michael Troon, Jimmy Buckley and Travis Polkinghorne. A little bit busier late in the second quarter. Give you East in a moment. This is an important kick from 50 and a beautiful kick. That's home, I reckon. Great goal, North. Is that the start of the fight back? Well, let's have a look at that goal, because that is the man who might have just ignited the Roosters.
Yes, Michael Hines there, nice kick, and just shepherded through for a goal. But I think some important moves that North have made, they've brought Chris Hill into the ruck, They've actually moved Dean Seeley up to centre-half forward, and I think they've just made some changes. Obviously, they had to make changes, but these are the sort of telling signs that really they need to really start to explain why they weren't playing so well in that first half.
Well, they're getting the ball out of the centre. They win the tap out, but it's East at the fall of the ball. The handball's on to the big ruckman here, and Ford, left foot, drives it down towards centre-half forward. Here's the two little chipmunks down here. Lead in the race for the ball. It's North, though. Have it out, half-back flank. Drive it back in towards the centre. The punch is on. It came off the hands of Quinlan, trying to get it forward. Now, North go forward again. Quinlan butters up well. The lead's on, and a good one taken here by Stuart Brown. Now, the big fellow's been moved. As Ian Baker said before, the removes all over the place at the moment, and we probably won't be able to sort them out until about 5 minutes into this quarter, but it's been a good start to North. And Brown will kick from about 47 metres. Left foot drop putt. Should have the wind behind him, but it's offline. So Brown puts another behind on the Gillies Pies scoreboard. They move on to 7-6-48 to 14-5-89. And as Ian Baker has told us, the Roosters will fight back. They're known for it. But to come from 47 points is a big ask.
Top East stat getters, Rob, in the first half. Peter O'Connell, Scott O'Donohue, Alister Ford, little Mark Orchard, and the top stats getter on the ground as East muck up the kick out there, Evans. Top stats getter on the ground, Gary Odgers. 16 possessions in the first half, just ahead of Peter O'Connell and Scott O'Donohue on 15. And the old biorhythms, we talk about them a lot. You just get the feeling North's up and East's down at the start of the second half.
Well, I think it just proved a point there with Tony Evans, very hesitant. And I think, you know, they've really just got to forget about East. They've just got to forget about, you know, whether North are going to come back or not. They've got to play with that desperation that they showed in that first half and just keep flowing.
Well, interesting to watch here. Odgers is going to come back and take the kick off after that last one, which they literally blew. And Odgers down there in that last line of defence, trying just to get, I think, some form of, discipline. But North are blocking off. They kick from outside. This looks all right. Superb goal. It's come from Quinlan. And I was just starting to say, Ian Baker, Odgers was down there because North was starting to block off. They weren't given the options. They were man on, toes on. And all of a sudden, we've seen the options shut down. And both times, they haven't had an option to kick out from fullback. And North looks like they might have turned the corner.
I hope to think that East are not thinking that they can just win the game by holding the game, because what's going to happen if they do it, and it looks like they're trying to do it, they're chipping the ball around to get possession, but that's not the way they're going to win it.
Well, it's back in the centre again. Margin back to 6 goals. East can't sit and wait. They've got to create something, but North have got it out of the centre again. And they're looking like the top side. We know they are. Great combination of handballs. It ends up here with Chaos Ryan. And it's home again. They have kicked 3 goals in 4 minutes. A great start to the second half for the Roosters. 9-7-61 to 14-5-89. And they're now doing it in numbers. And they're playing now with a bit of poise and a bit of confidence, Bakes.
Yeah, I think just Chris Hill's out of the centre. I think that's an important part that we're going to see here. You know, Alister has really, been dominant in there, and they've got to really stop that supply.
Comments from Ian Baker, ex-North Ballarat, Redan and Italy coach here in the Ballarat Football League. And I think it'd been barking a long time ago that Lewis should have been moved into the centre.
Yep.
So maybe Jimmy Buckley's got the message. Back to the centre again. Hills was the man that Bakes wanted back there as well. The big punch comes out. But North, now for a chance, have runners and footballers and players at the fall of the ball. But the long arms go up there of East Ballarat, and the mark has been taken. Off hands, quickly, out here to Orchard. The little fellow's off. He'll run, drive it towards half forward. But there's nobody home, and that's the only thing I don't like about his play, Orchard. He gets enough possessions, but they've got to be positive possessions. Back to centre wing, and a mark's being taken in front of him here. North Ballarat looking good. Player there driving it towards half forward, off hands to the ground, far side of the ground. Picking it up here is Simpson, and Simpson's kick smothered. And we're now starting to see North Ballarat doing the things that East did in the first half.
He's playing with a lot of confidence. East have just got to sort of try and play positive football, not holding football.
Jimmy Buckley, we thought, might have been carrying an injury, but he's there. Whoops, and he's there. Right. And I think the book might come out.
I think it has come out.
And a few words from Gary Odgers to his opposition captain coach, Jimmy Buckley. And I doubt, Rob, whether they were organising dinner this evening, just quietly.
Well, it's a yellow card. It's a yellow card, and Buck will come to the bench and is going to have to coach from the side of the bench for 15 minutes. So Jimmy Buckley not real happy with that, but I suppose it's early in the third quarter. Here it is on replay. Whoops, I don't think there's too much we have to worry about that, Buck. When you have a look at that back in replay, I think you'll agree with this fella. Back under play. O'Connell it is, spins, nobody home, off hands, they can set it up here north, running players everywhere, up to the ground, they look up here for O'Donoghue, in front, no, to the back, Mark Evans trying to claim, it didn't happen, the player there was Hines actually for North Ballarat, not O'Donoghue, now they're off, the Bulldogs, this is O'Connell, and looks out here and finds O'Donoghue on this occasion, centre wing, should put it into the centre, Smokey Dawson on his own, has time to go, but what's going to happen, I feel this is going to be relayed further down the ground.
Yes, it is.
Now, you had your eyes peeled down there, Ian Baker. Tell me what's happened. The player with it, though, is Matthew Cox.
Yeah, Troon had him by the jumper coming in through the centre-half forward area there.
Aren't you allowed to do that?
Not when the ball's not in 10 yards.
You can if you can get away with it. Underway again. A little bit of desperation. Lewis, handballs, centre wing. The crowd coming to life, Shane Healy.
Oh, yes, they certainly are. This grand final has really fired itself up now with these three early goals to the North Ballarat Roosters, looking for their 50th win in a row in this Ballarat Football League and their third flag in succession. At the moment, they're down by five goals and they force it toward the centre line. There's nearly a great mark.
Gotta be.
We're going to play it, are we? There was a good, interesting battle there between Quinlan and his big East Ballarat opponent. And that, of course, is the best man on the ground, Alister Ford. Gets the hand pass across to Dawson. He comes across the ground. Here towards centre wing, grandstand side. A little bit of pushing and shoving. I thought Odgers was legged. Umpire finally saw it. Very late, I might add. Odgers leading from the front. Best possession getter on the ground. Chip short to half forward flank. He's got James O'Connell, who tries to hand pass backwards. In the end, fails badly, and Cushion takes it for North. Drives down toward the centre. It's tapped on. Almost to the good of Sealy, who's out at centre half forward, but Ford relieves. Well done to James O'Connell. He'll chip short. Well done.
How good a vision was that of Ford?
Terrific. Great player. Now, that was barely 10 metres to find Stevens there, by the way.
Here they go again, short.
Chipping around.
And they're finding out here. This is Odgers again. Gee, he's covering some territory. I wonder whether it'll be their undoing, but they've got the speed. Whyte it is from the pocket. Shocking kick. And goes over the line right in front of the SCN News Sports sign.
They haven't actually scored this quarter, East, in 10 minutes, Bakes.
Yeah, I think, I do believe that they're playing for possession only. Hopefully it doesn't let them down.
Well, let's have a look now at the Roosters. Bring it back into play. Just waiting and waiting and waiting for options right there in front of the SCN sign. In the end, Kennedy, a relatively quiet Kennedy by his standards. His fairly lofty standards, I might add. Finally takes the mark and decides to go for a gallop. And gallop he does. Down the grandstand side. Big long kick. Looking for Cushion. He nearly took a spectacular mark. Out emerges Blood. Hand passes to Ford. Inside it goes. Good play off to Peter O'Connell. Down toward the attacking 50. White's the rover. Just couldn't take it with him. Ooh, strong stuff there. Danny Holloway knew what it hit him, Rob. And it was the little bombshell. Cox, Orchard, another. They're both wearing the long sleeves and both real goers today.
Cox it was. Good football. Knew that they were in trouble. North out of defence. Oh, a la Danaher. Didn't work. And the ball's gone over the line and out of bounds.
That really got people talking, that Chris Danaher.
Didn't it?
Shove in the grand final, didn't it?
Oh, I think only the old experienced ones can do those breaks, can't they?
Especially when you get a bit slower.
Those words from Ian Baker. And I'll leave it at that, Hoss.
Yes.
I won't bring you undone.
Thank you.
Well, who's lifted for North, in your opinion, Bakes? We know it's a general team lift.
Can't really individualise on anyone, but I think they're just getting more power out of the centre, and I think that's where they got those thrust of three goals there.
Well, the thrust this time's from Whyte. Drives it long. Good mark. And that ball fell short. Now, I didn't see whether there was a player pushed out at the back, but the umpires paid the mark, and Ford was in the right spot at the right time. We saw it happen at the other end in that second quarter. Have a look at it on replay. The ball comes in short. When you're in front, as you said before, Shane, it's got to work for you.
Well, it what a game this big man's playing, Ian. I mean, he has done everything all over the ground, defence, attack and in the centre.
There's certainly been a great team strategy that that Gary's brought in here. He certainly has worked Alister to try and get a little bit of height in their forward line, but also not to lose him around the ground, and this bloke's playing very good football.
Well, the 29-year-old comes in looking for goal number 5. From just on 50, left foot drop partners are coming back. I yes. think it might. Oh, goal.
I do.
And we do too at Barry Smith Honda. During spring, we promise to do prices better than anyone. Call in and meet my staff or myself and have us do a bigger and better deal for you. Combined with Honda's renowned reliability and quality, big city trade-ins and good old country service means an all-round better deal for you. Come and do it now. Do it at Barry Smith Honda, Ballarat.
Alister Ford's 5th goal, and now he's contesting the ruck knockout, but this time it's the north side. Working it out of the centre. Well done, Travis Mulkinghorn, getting busier. Only as far this time as Carl Haseloff. And Haseloff from the back of the square. Oh, that's a nice mark. Is that Peter O'Connell? No, it's not. Cox. It's little Cox. Well done. Gets the hand past to Jax. He goes down to the forward line, and out comes Gladman to take a mark out near the boundary. Yes. Here's his kick. Oh, I tell you what, he's kicked that terrifically. What a goal, Gladman. Oh, a beauty.
Yes, another good goal, and I think really the initiative has been turned around a little bit. East have got a little bit of a flow here, but they're not just chipping the ball, they're actually using the ball better now, and that's what they've got to do if they want to still keep in front.
Well, they've nearly got a three-pronged attack down in that forward zone. They've got the option of Gladman, they've got the option of Dawson, even the little fellows down there, and also Ford.
Yeah, five goals, Ford.
Three players to kick to. And if you can run around and make position down there amongst three key players on your forward line, believe you me, your opponents can't keep running all day doing that. North get it out of the centre quickly. Looking up here for Seeley. Good punch away to the ground. Umpire should put a whistle on play. Now he lets it go. They're going to get out of this, North. With, over the top of the ball in desperation. Odgers pushed to the ground. Still play goes on. I think I would like to have heard a whistle a little bit earlier.
Hasn't Odgers led from the front, Ian?
Yes, played very well. Just a very good marshal of the troops.
Ball up. Push down. Here's Orr, off hands, quickly, good tackle through the pack, or break through the pack, out here to Hines. Hines goes nowhere, and again, out of defence, Simpson, centre wing, who's home? Hits a young Whyte on the top of the head, it's going to go over the line and out of bounds, or is it still in? No, Whyte, he can still, just goes over and beats him, unfortunately. Whyte thought it was going over, picked up momentum, tried to keep it in, but unfortunately has beaten him over the line and out of bounds. Had a break of about 5 or 6 metres too. Would have been very handy for Bulldogs fans.
Hasn't he got some pace, Whyte? He and Orchard. Wow, can those two guys run?
The punch. Orr has a chance, leaves it behind. In fact, went straight over the top of the ball, throwing himself over the top was McInerney. And the umpire now said, excuse me, guys, I think I'll have it. Ball right on centre wing, grandstand side, the City Oval. Let's check the Gillies Pies scoreboard.
Well, 16-5-101. That is East, the underdogs, the Bulldogs. North, going for their 50th win straight, but they're pushing uphill at the moment. 9-7-61, the margin 40 points as the ball comes spinning back into play.
Spinning back into play, Dawson off the ground, pushes it out to the open spaces of Jax. He's being hotly pursued. Dawson, quickly back, good hands to Odgers. The coach lets fly, now the race is on. Look at this fella go, Whyte. Shane Healy said before he had a ton of speed. Nearly left his boots behind. Cleverly dodges. Into centre half forward. The lead's on. No mark. Pressure came from Ford. Pushing it to the ground. That's Ford for North. Again, East. Oh, good tackle put on him on that occasion. Pockinghorn wasn't rewarded. And I thought for a fleeting moment, North could have got a free kick from centre half back. This is precious stuff. 101 plays 61. Umpire content to throw that ball into the air. There must be a few soft spots. I did say before that I reckon it could be a little bit heavy onto the foot out there, or underfoot out there. Odgers sees an option, gets floored, and the umpire should let play go on. They do, yes. Odgers got floored after he got rid of it. Over the top of the ball is Gladman. Now the big fellow comes in and tries to pick it up again, and we'll see a boundary throw in. Far side of the ground, highway side, 48 and a bit metres out from the attacking zone of East Ballarat.
And a little bit of work for the old binoculars here as it comes back into play, and Matt Stevens gets the tap down for East. But North will clear very indirectly, really. It was just a kick anywhere, and East with 3-on-1. Johnny Orr can't win that battle. Ends up with Haseloff, sideways to Simpson, and he's on the burst. The left footer from the front of the square into the pocket. Anyone home? Well, no one to take the mark. Alister Ford hits the post. Well, if he's not taking marks, roving. He's roving and kicking goals. He's unbelievable.
Well, he's two players playing their last game here, and supposedly that's Odgers and Ford.
Yes, well, it's hard to see after today's performance whether he can hang the boots up.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more with that. There is a good shot of the man who is heading at the moment easily the best on the ground status, is Jason Berry, with that unique haircut. Kicks it in. Looks out toward half-back flank. Haseloff had the chance. Overran it. Odgers just working. Off to Peter O'Connell. Peter O'Connell down toward full forward. Anyone home? Well, Peter Whyte went up, or Paull Whyte it was, but it's Michael Troon, I fancy, at the back. He's taken a pretty steady mark there. We call that true centre half-back. And gets the North Roosters running. Down toward the centre. Pushing was needed. No one could take the mark. O'Connell again. Clever handball. Chance here now for the little fellow in O'Donohue to go in. He loses out. Kick that goes further up than it goes forward for North. Really to nobody's advantage, but that's good work. Bursting through there, one of the Polkinghorne boys. Might have been Travis. Long down to half forward. Good bounce for Evans. Beats Seeley. Has a bounce. He loves a trot, this fellow. He's had two. And now wobbles one to the boundary, which will be chased by Sean Holloway.
I don't really think that's as bad a football as it looked, Ian Baker. There were no options down the ground.
No, he certainly was a very well-judged kick.
So at the throw-in, Bills goes up and taps down. Not all that well, but in the end, their hand passes worked across to McInerney. He'll kick to Seeley. Good spoil, Evans. Well worked, James O'Connell at ground level to lock it up there. Comes to the outside of the pack. North needs a goal here. Johnny Orr working it forward. Hand pass really to nobody. Look at that body work by Evans. He's in my votes at the moment. Gets it across to little Cox, who goes short. Just over the top of Jacks. It was ready-made had it gone in the right spot. But in the end, the Gillies brothers' sign wins out. There you can see it. In the words of the famous Dick Turner, Gillies is the pie that fills and never kills. It's the pie of flavour, Robbie. It's full of meat, and it is a treat to eat.
The poet laureate, Shane Healy, playing away again. North Ballarat desperate, but East Ballarat throwing as much as they can back at them. 27, this is Polkinghorne. On the left foot, drives it towards that scoreboard side. Has it just been trapped inside? I think it might be out on the full.
Yep.
And the free kick will go to East. Everything is going their way at the moment. And taking this kick is at Haseloff from that back pocket. And they're content to chip it short again. Gee, that worries me, but it's working.
They've done it to perfection, you've got to say that.
I think they've been watching Essendon.
I was just thinking the same thing.
It's worked for them, I suppose it can work for them as well.
No, I think they're just looking for possession. They know they haven't got any tall guy, you know, the strike power in the air as much as North
has.
Yeah,
it's Collard.
As long as they don't sort of overdo it.
Oh, cool.
Good start.
A la Michael Long. If you want it, come and get it. Well, Evans, you had nowhere to go. In the long term, it was good football. And found a teammate in Jacks. Beautiful. Good stuff. East Ballarat far side of the ground. This is O'Connell. James should let fly from half-back flank. Not a good kick, though. Falling short. Will it be kept in? No. Over the line. And we'll see a free kick go the way of North Ballarat. You've got the glasses, Shane. I'm going to ask you to help me.
Yeah, actually, sorry. I was just looking at the other end of the ground, Robbie.
Chris Hills.
Chris Hills it is.
It's 20 minutes of the quarter gone, and North has only made up one goal. They are in big trouble, the Roosters.
Odgers, the coach, finds blood going past. Blood races through the centre. Wobbly old kick, though. Players not kicking the ball well at all. Good mark from Wolak, or a lucky one, let's say. Wolak off hands to Blood again. He's off. Through the centre on the charge towards full forward. Where's the big fellow at the back forward? A little slow on that occasion. The ball falling short. Here's a chance. Picked up for North Ballarat through Ryan. Chaos Ryan, centre wing. Has a teammate. Bounces well for him. They'll bring it in. Looking out here for Seeley. No. Dawson and Seeley. Oh, cleverly tapped back by Seeley, but not a throw, the umpire says, and pushed into the ground. Free kick will be against O'Connell here, and it will go to North Ballarat and should go to Michael Hines.
Yep.
Hines with one goal to his credit in this quarter. Looks in towards centre half forward. Over the top of the lead there of the big fellow there in brown. Here's a snap. Nobody at home, though, or is it going to beat him? Oh! Well, the luckiest of lucky goals. Two to Quinlan, 102 plays 67. Ian Baker, you would have to put that down as a lucky one.
Yes, for sure. It was very hard on the east defence there. It was spiralling in the air and, he just got mesmerised with it.
Well, Simpson gets first possession out of the centre and runs it out toward that far wing. A good shot there of the Ballarat Courier sign. Another great traditional newspapers of regional Victoria, the Ballarat Courier. And Jimmy Murphy, of course, one of their great journalists over the years, as part of the new Ballarat Centenary book that's been written, as Jimmy Buckley comes back onto the ground. And can he lift his charges? Nice chip across there, Sean Holloway. Getting better in this quarter. Finds the centreman, Wes Lewis. Do you think he's been in the centre this quarter, Bakes?
No, I think he's still playing off a half forward.
Do you? Okay, so there he is, on the left foot. Down to centre half forward. Evans couldn't take that mark. Almost for Michael Hines. Tried to just feed out what we call quick hands, but just couldn't do so, and it's a ball up.
Ian, players just not kicking the ball well this quarter.
Yeah, it has been a marked sort of sight that the ball's not flowing well, whether they've changed the ball or whatever.
Here come the Roosters again. Big long kick down in the brown direction. It bounces to the back. Now they've got to be desperate here, Eastern defence, and well done, well worked. Nice play. Cook across to Haseloff. Ends up there with James O'Connell, busy this quarter. He chips one short to Jacks at defensive 50, had nowhere to go, and kicked it straight toward McInerney of North, who goes long on the right foot to full forward. Look out for Brown, he's up, but he's been beaten. Marcus Wolak, good mark.
And he was determined to take it off the back too.
He did it well. I just wonder if he stole it out of Brown's hands, whether Brown didn't get first grab at it. He's not happy with umpire Steve Haintz. Old Ballarat Aquinas student and St. Pat's teacher.
No, I'll give it to the man behind on that occasion.
So fair mark to Wolak, says Robbie Gaylard. But the kick is marked by North. So they've got to get a goal now as they mount this attack.
Yes, certainly they've got a very clustered forward line here at the moment, Shane.
Very crowded, not too many options, so Lewis just goes long. Wolak, no way this time. In the end, you cannot play from behind, Marcus Wolak. And this time, it's going to be the big man of North, Dean Seely. He brought it down pretty impressively.
Yes, played very well there. I think they've moved him out to centre-half forward. I don't know whether I agree with that. I think I'd sooner see him up in the key position role there and maybe even have someone a little bit smaller at centre-half forward with a little bit of mobility.
Here's the kick from 25 metres out right in front. He's got four, and now he's got five. An important kick. He would have had a second go had he needed it, but umpire Haint says all clear.
Roosters close the margin, 102-73 on the Gillies Pie scoreboard. East Ballarat, Ian Baker, just noticing in the last 10 minutes, every time they're getting it from half back, it's been cut off.
Yes, they have. They've sort of dropped their momentum a little bit now, and whether they've dropped or whether North have picked up, but it seems to be that North have got the flow a bit at the moment.
Well, across that half-forward line for East Ballarat, it's all North Ballarat jumpers, and they've taken another mark outside 50 here. They'll need to get it moving quickly. The lead's on down here by Brown in front. Yes! And the big fellow takes a grab.
Goes against what I was saying there before when I said probably Seely may have wanted to come back and probably have another sort of more mobile player centre-half forward, but Brown's probably, taking a nice grab there.
Stuart Brown, left foot drop punt, wobbly one, I think it might be only behind. No, it's at his edge that bit close to the goal. Umpire had me fooled well and truly, Shane Healy. Started touching the chest. Maybe he wanted to kickstart the pacemaker.
Well, East need a goal now. Orchard down toward the forward line. There's only 23 points the difference in the grand final. North, the consummate pros, have fought their way back. And it's been a few of their lesser lights that have got them back into it. Sean Holloway and Danny Holloway and Ratboy Ross McInerney, who gets a possession up toward the half forward line. Punched away by the East defenders. Well taken, Whyte. Run down by Orr. But he still kicks on to half forward where North is beginning to dominate. And a mark made that shouldn't have been, but Jason Berry's going to claim it. At least he got the body in front. At least North has taken the initiative. On the right foot, down beyond the centre. Here's the man East's needed all day. Big Alister Ford comes across, takes a timely mark. Off to Evans, who's run down. Kicks down to the half forward line. Ball just keeps rebounding from there. And that's going to happen again. Caius Ryan, well done. Sideways across to Hills. And Hills now down. Well, no one home this time. And Dawson takes the mark for East Ballarat. Runs almost to the wing, gets a few hoots. And drives down toward half forward. Up they go. There's that man again, Danny Holloway. Couldn't take the mark that time, but that North half back line working terrifically. Simpson and Dawson spoil each other. No talk. A little indicative of East in the last 10 minutes. We're going to have a ball up. It's 30 minutes, third quarter. And at this stage of the Melbourne Grand Final, Carlton had edged back to 4 or 5 goals. And we felt maybe the Blues had a sniff. East's got to really take a hold now as Ford goes for the safety of the boundary. Comments from North Ballarat legend Ian Baker.
Yes, there's a lot of football still to be played in this game. And as Shane, you said, I think it really, you know, East, they've got to go out with the idea of winning the game, not trying to hold the game.
Well, Dawson put under an enormous amount of pressure. Buckley back on for North Ballarat. The coach is on the ground now to lead them. Up towards the centre of that diamond, well, the centre of that 50 metres. And they're going to have a chance to put it forward into the zone. Can't do so. Good pressure. Handball from Whyte. Out wide. Evans, you can almost back it in. Evans will defend from that back line every time. And chips it in and finds his teammate there in big Alister Ford. Ford, with 5 goals to his credit, been a superb contributor. As most of my co-commentators have got him at the moment as BOG. He is for mine too. Well trapped. Good football there. That was cushion. Trapped it well, but let himself down badly with a handball. Now Ford with a handball across to O'Connell. O'Connell finds a short one into the centre. Finds Odgers. He was behind his opponent on that occasion. How'd he get in front? Out wide to Whyte. Now they're chipping the ball everywhere. East, the runners are on. Should find Blood. Does so. Could have gone for a run, Blood, but he finds a player at centre half forward. Puts up the one hand. Is it Orchard?
Yes.
The little fellow. Left foot. Someone all on their own. No. Punched away at the last moment. Good football. Kennedy it was. In that last line of defence. Here's a chance here now for Gladman. And Gladman maybe collared a bit high.
Oh,
no.
Shocking.
It's gone the other way. Made no attempt, the umpire says.
You can't get tackled around the neck. That's disgraceful.
Well, he's at 10 metres. We're at 310.
Try half a mile.
We are a bit that way, I must admit. Into the centre. Punches away. Off hands. Berry trying to set something up. North lucky to get back to where they are. Mark in front. Good hands. And this is Dean Seely further down the ground. Pushes off and he'll go the other way here.
Shocking.
Leonard Buck. Jimmy Buckley is not real happy at all. And I think the crowd and the co-commentators tend to agree with you, Buck.
Yeah, I don't know what that was for, really. I think that all he done was try to play on, and he's got past the player, the East player in Tony Evans, and he's been pulled back for some reason.
Tried to push him off with a hand on the way past. Now, whether he's pushed him off too high or whether the umpire felt that it was more a punch than a push, that's the only thing I can read into it. But Paul grandstand side. Here's the replay. Let's have a look at it. Now, you'll find here, oh, no, when we look at it back on replay, maybe
yes.
The case was there.
Yeah, I think that probably, certainly wasn't the right thing to do.
Well, the Roosters have edged a little bit closer. Let's check the Gillies Pies scoreboard. 12-7, Rays 16-6. We'll be back. Have a look at the highlights. Can the Roosters get back? We'll find out shortly.
In final quarters or third quarters, I think this one's going to develop into the fourth. Can they get back?
Well, that's a very
hard one. I think
it's going to be a hard one, but who could ask for a better finish than this?
Shane?
I don't think they'll win, but I think we're going to have just a fabulous finish. And they kicked goals early in the quarter, Rob, and then East answered with a couple, and all of a sudden, I remember saying at the 20-minute mark, hey, they've only won the quarter by a goal, and then late in the quarter, a couple of big marks. That was a good goal, by the way, kicked by Brett Quinlan, one of his couple today out near the boundary.
And Dawn started that third quarter, though, in great fashion. 3 quick goals, and all of a sudden it looked like they were going to run back. East took stock. Here's a good play being set up here, this time coming off the hands of Tyus Ryan, and this one bounced right through. A couple of lucky goals, actually, for Ryan on that for North in that quarter. But I really do believe, I tend to agree with Ian, Jimmy Buckley's unfortunately there, copped 15 minutes for that little incident. But unfortunately for Buck, I think perhaps the bird might have flown for North. It's going to be a superhuman effort for them. But I agree with Ian Baker by saying East have got to play to win the grand final, not keep possession of the ball and say, OK, we're 4 or 5 goals in front of three-quarter time. All we've got to do is just stop their momentum.
Yeah, they can't afford to try and save it. Alister Ford's the key, surely, Bakes. I mean, he's done work all over the ground, hasn't he?
Yes, for sure. And I think that's where it's going to come down to, whether, if East tries to hold and just plays a defensive game, you'll find that mistakes will be made and the ball will be turned over and North, can crucify a side.
North weren't in the huddle for very long. Alan Besley had his ear for a short time there to Jim Buckley.
Well, Jim Buckley has told his players to kick long, be hard and direct at the ball in the last quarter and power on. He wants to run straight at East Ballarat players. He praised Hill's top effort in the centre square and he told them to keep persisting. The cup is still within their grasp.
Well, John Dunn was down there. JD, we could hear Gary Odgers up here in our commentary box and we're a mile and a half away from him.
Yes, you certainly could have, Rob. He told his backline players to use the ball better when they come out of that backline. He asked his players who were quiet in that third quarter to lift. He said his team was in the same position 2 weeks ago. Don't let it slip this time. He asked to keep the pressure on this last quarter. He said the entire year's work was lasted for all up to this last 25 minutes of the whole year's work, Rob.
Well, 72 plays 102. In fact, I make a mistake. 79 plays 102 on the Gillies Spies scoreboard. Gary Odgers on screen urging his players. 134 to 166. And I ask you again, Ian Baker, I think the stats tell the story. 166 kicks to East Ballarat, 134 to North Ballarat. And I think, as I said before, that does tell the story. But the mark 62 to 37, I think that's honestly saying that perhaps the dominance of what we thought North being a tall side would take over has turned the opposite way.
Yeah, but I think the marks have been taking out front on chest and they haven't been taking overhead, and this is where they're using the ball properly and they're bringing the ball into their forward line out in front.
Well, the last quarter's about to get underway in the Ballarat Football League Grand Final. North down by 23 points. It was dead level in the second semi with 15 minutes to go and North kicked the last eight. They've had the week off. East had a tough one last week to get through. Is it going to be the Roosters to come home or can the Bulldogs hold on? Johnny Orr up there on the half forward line. Feet out of hand pass to McInerney. But he kicks it straight to the man I reckon will call a lot in this last quarter. He might be what's standing between North and the flag. Big Alister Ford traverses the square with what breeze there is, and it looks like there still is a little bit. Down looking here for Gladman at half forward, but North win it away again. Their half back line is terrific. McInerney has it stolen. In goes Lewis. He had 11 possessions in the third quarter. He's lifted his work rate enormously. It's in the centre. Ball to be won. Who's going to take it? Jax. He can't take it. Oh, good work, North Ballarat. In goes Sean Holloway. Hand passes to Caius Ryan, who's been pretty good. He comes off centre half back and drives up to centre half forward. Should be a free kick to North here. Not paid. Gee whiz, I thought Big Sealy going to shove. Own man, says Rob. Thank you. And the ball wobbles over the boundary line. Half forward flank for North.
Yeah, I think Michael Hines came in from behind, and that was where the push came from.
So we've got a throw in. Wes Lewis, Michael Hines, Travis Polkinghorne, Caius Ryan and Jason Berry, the big stat getters. A lot of those off across that half-back line for North in that third quarter. They're working back. They're only 23 points down after being 8 goals behind. And Rugby Thatcher, they're forcing it up beyond the centre. There's been a player shoved here, surely. It's got to be a Bulldog free kick. And they'll work it out wide where Marcus Wolak, not a bad player today, takes it on the half-back line. And he's got a player further out here on the wing, all on his own. Peter Jacks, who drives on the right foot. Good lead, good pass, and happily accepted by Gary Odgers. Been an absolute star for East today. Had 11 possessions in the third quarter to give him 27 for the game.
Odgers driving in front. North Ballarat have the mark at the back, though. And the good hands there of Michael Troon. Alister Ford asking the question. Troon it is, though. Drives back to where it came from in front. Unfortunately, a little bit of height advantage over Gary Odgers there. And this is Jason Berry. North have got to move the ball just a bit quicker for mine. You can't stand and prop. You want to win a grand final. They've picked a player out almost on centre wing. The ball stays a bit soft there. Picked up by Simpson into the centre from behind. Right idea. The punch was on, but the players were at the fall of the ball. Troon leads now. Overrun. Oh, traps it back. Troon was gone then for mine for North. Got it back. The tackle's put on here by O'Donoghue on his North Ballarat opponent. Whyte, the speedy Whyte, gets off a handball across here to Wolak. Wolak sets fly right into centre half forward off the back of the pack. Gladman with a chance. Collin without the ball, pushed into the ground. Play on. Dawson's in there. North will get away with this. Stacks on the mill.
And Rob, just for about 3 seconds, Alister Ford stood on his own in the goal square.
I saw it.
Just a lucky dribble out, and it would have been a major. And I reckon the first goal of this last quarter is going to mean everything.
I think that's what I preempted, or why I preempted that North will get out of it, because only had to have the loose kick on the handball, and Ford was home. A chance again. O'Connell drives into the square. O'Connell's kick truly. Let's have a look at this on replay. That last goal at the moment, the handball of Ford found O'Connell.
And look at this one float right into the square. As I said, Shane Healy, I think his statement might have almost been qualified.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's five goals and this is one heck of a task for North. They're kicking into a slight breeze. It's tougher to kick goals down that city end. But it's with Dean Seeley at the moment. A poor kick up to the front of the square. You can't make mistakes now, North. You've got to kick goals. And here they go. Johnny Orr, well tackled. Up on half four, taken by the busy Jacks. He drives back toward the centre. Almost a good steal. In fact, the steal's been affected. This is Cox. He's on his way. Kicks on left foot down in the Dawson direction. Dawson plays his opponent under the ball. He chases. But in the end, North Ballarat will see it to the safety of the boundary. And it's over for a throw-in. Well, that little Cox today, number 45, and also little Orchard, number 43, with Whyte, number 1, they have been absolutely terrific. Here's the throw-in on the East attacking 50. Fine palm down Stevens in the direction of Odgers, and also Jacks goes to Dawson. Hand passes to Stevens. Nice vision. Great mark, Cox. Or Orchard, I think, this time.
Orchard.
Well, they're both little superstars. Cox has tricked me a couple of times. He's played some quarters in long sleeves and some in short. This boy at least is consistent, Robbie Orchard. He's been in the long sleeves all day. And he is going to kick from right on 50. This goal will win them the premiership if it goes through, in my opinion. But it hasn't gone through, so I reckon we've still got a ball game. It's an even five goals in the Ballarat Grand Final. 17-7-109 East, 12-7-79 North. That is 5 minutes into the last quarter on the Gillies Pies scoreboard.
Hockinghorn offering the shorts. It's going to be ignored. It'll be driven out towards our grandstand side of broadcast position at Holloway in front. Short Holloway. And Buckley starts to make a move on centre wing towards him. Looks for his coach. Can he mark it? He does. And Buckley offloads quickly to Hockinghorn. This is Grant. Centre wing. Halfway between centre wing and half forward. Runs down, looks for the shorts again, Hockinghorn. Clever, left foot, should put it into a lead. Looks in here for his player in Lewis. No, no one home. East defend well, desperation, and they head straight for the boundary line. Well, Grant Hockinghorn had seen that the only way to go was down that grandstand wing and try and chip it in towards centre half forward. But the defence of East has been well. Or has done well. Evans been a great contributor. Off hands. Buckley goes to an opposition player. Centre wing. Two East players lead in the race. This is Stevens. Matty Stevens chips it in. Finds a teammate. Out to the speech to Whyte. Has a panic and a half. One bounce. Two. Has a run. Looks in towards centre half. Two options. And I'll give you one guess who's got it. Big Alister Ford. And you could see it building up all the time, Ian Baker, as the two options were let out. And what North Ballarat were thinking, I do not know, because they signalled that at centre wing.
Yes, for sure, Rob. And they brought that down nicely and certainly leaving a lot of space for Alister to run into. And he is certainly playing a little man's game in a big man's uniform.
I'll remember that one. Alister Ford going for goal number 6. Shane Healy has the glasses on him. He'll kick from 45, lays back on the ball, that to me.
Well, I reckon Easter Premiers here. They are 6 goals up. The underdog is going to win it, and they burst out of the centre again. O'Donohue down toward full forward. Dawson, did he get a high tackle? Umpire said no. Danger, Orchard in the goal square, and he misses. Oh, dear me, 18-8, 116 to 12-7, 79. And Buckley's black and white rampant Roosters, who have been the outstanding side of Ballarat footy for 3 years, who were today going for win number 50 in succession, are going to be beaten by Gary Odger's brave young Bulldogs, who arrested the supremacy early, and as so often happens in a grand final, they've held it, and they're going to win this. It's on their attacking 50, picked up by Peter O'Connell. The leaper is Wolak. Oh, he's got it. And don't they love it out there, Ian Baker?
For sure. If you have a look at the screen now, Shane, there was about 5 East players into their square area and only 1 North Ballarat player. They're playing very loose at the moment.
Wolak's only 15 metres out. And it's home. Well, is it. 19-8, 122 to 12-7-79, 43 points in front. Stick the Stags on down at the East Ballarat barbecue, Robbie, because we're going out there shortly.
Well, you'd almost give that the mark of the day to Wolak. Turned himself inside out in mid-air. Great goal.
He certainly had to sit on Michael Troon there, but there was five of them to one, and the ball rebounded and they were caught.
Well, the North Ballarat boys are really going to have to lift. Easter on fire. They get it out of the centre of the game, out to centre wing. Good even match duel. Pace is going to win out for North Ballarat. The handball off to Orr. Nobody home though. It's all Bulldogs. This is Sean Blood. Traps it. Gets it to nobody though. Fighting there is Evans. They still keep possession. Desperation by both sides. Loose handball. Trapped here by Blood again. Umpire quite happy to let it go. North could get a let off. Oh, good collar. A good tackle. Buckley puts the handball out wide. Here finds Pockinghorn. Pockinghorn's kick wide to Ford. Now Andrew Ford should score from here.
Been very quiet, Rob.
Been terribly quiet. And a player who, going into this game on past experience, you would have thought would have had a lot more touches. You would have thought would have had a lot more possessions. Ford has already got one. Let's see whether he can make it two. No, it falls short. Play still underway, touched through from behind.
Yes, Andrew the last game had to stand out because of suspension. He's come back today, but certainly should have had more influence in the game.
And he's quite content. In fact, they're almost getting cheeky about it. Came unstuck on that occasion. The little chip pass. Doesn't matter how far in front you are. Concentration for 120 minutes. That's how long it takes. They've got a sniff of the grand final. I think they can nearly start popping the corks. This is Odgers. The coach, the handball, across here, looking for Cox. I can hear a whistle on play, and I think a little bit of rough stuff on that halfback line. We'll see a free kick go back to North Ballarat. Just off the play before, we saw a bit of rough stuff in the crowd. I'd say it'd be a seven suture job for one little fellow we spotted, but North are on fire, into the pocket, offline. And what's going to happen here? I reckon there'll be a free kick played to North here.
Holding the man, Rob.
It is. And I'll get you to pick the player for me. It looks like Quinlan.
Yeah, he's kicked a couple too. A couple of really good snaps in that third quarter.
Correct. Quinlan it is. We'll edge them a little bit closer, but I think the bird might have flown. They move to 13.
And a great shot there of the boundary umpires in action there, swooping on the footy, relaying it over to the central umpire, Stephen Haynes. And he puts it into the turf now as I speak. And there's the bounce. And they give that tap down to East. Big forward. Both ends of the ground being terrific. North work it out with first possession. Really only went out toward the wing. Well trapped East. In went Jax. Lost out that time to Michael Hines, who got it to Lewis. Chips it on. Should be a goal here. Sealy should go over the top. No, he'll kick now. And he's kicked just offline. Bad miss. Might have given them a little bit of momentum there, that one, Bates. A bad miss.
Good play by the East defender then. He could have came out to meet Dean Sealy. He opted to drop back and to put pressure on Sealy to run a bit further. Then he came out at him and he's had to pull his shot.
So at the kick out. Oh, I thought Chris Hills might have got a shove there. Big Alister Ford, hasn't he? Been magnificent. Off to his captain coach. And they just work it along the outer wing, East. They've had contributors all over the ground. He is one of the best of them. O'Donohue was marvellous in the first half. Got possession after possession. Off to his captain coach again, who drives up toward Dawson. Kicked a couple of early goals and has really been a firebolt up there in that forward line. Down to attacking 50 comes the footy. Wolak took that superb mark earlier. Weighs it along in front of him. In goes Troon, been a desperate defender. And we've got a call up.
Dawson's got great recovery skills.
Yes, he has sort of, the second half hasn't been as good as his first half, but very instrumental in there.
Yeah, too awkward in the ruck that time. Jason Berry up with the knees, feet into his opponent. And the free kick will go to Wolak. Now Wolak can roost one if he gets onto it. Wolak gone for the short stage, looked for the lead of Ford, and it's dropped short. Lucky, got a hand on it. I thought it was going to be marked by North Ballarat. I thought Alister was too far behind the play. Johnny Orr draws the handball across the top. Puts a teammate, Holloway, under a bit of pressure. He has to offload quickly here to Quinlan. Quinlan to Buckley. Breaks the tackle. Jimmy Kinney have a kick in towards the centre. Good vision. Finds a teammate. and they're off the Roosters. Shocking kick though from McInerney, and this will put a hold on play again, and we'll see a bounce down emanate.
Yes, it was certainly running then. That was a poor disposal.
Build up. Bad kick coming there from Ross McInerney. But good vision from Buckley. Punch out. Taken there by Seely in the direction of their goals. The punch. Good football. Odgers had no option. He headed straight for the boundary line. Oh, snapped back and a good pickup. I thought for a moment it could have been on the half volley. It looks like Lewis. Wes Lewis it is. Would have knocked the tops of the daisies, but it's gone onto the chest, into the goal square. From behind, will they force it through? They do. Good defensive work from East Ballarat.
They're struggling to kick it more than 40 metres this quarter into that breeze, which just suggests to me it might, even though it doesn't look to be all that strong, still might be swirling around a little bit down there.
Yeah, it's hard to say. I thought, you know, when Alister Ford kicked that goal in the third quarter up there, it might have sort of eased a little bit.
East cheekily bring it out from fullback. Handball over the top. This is to Odgers. To centre wing. The race is on. Just read it a little indifferently. The East Ballarat player there in O'Connell and allows Polkinghorn in to kick into Buckley. Oh, Buckley had the kick smothered. The handball's on. Cleverly turned. Can McInerney make up for the mistake he made before? Good pass. Good pass. Find Seely. And I'll forgive him for the mistake he made earlier.
You can see why they are such a good side. When they're allowed to do something with the footy, they do look most impressive.
Yeah, they've got very good skills. Certainly, that was a good passage of play from Grant Poggin. He's playing very well here at the moment. And they'd certainly need, you know, the understatement is they need this goal. But, you know, I think really, as you said there before, Shane, it's very hard for anyone to come back at this time.
Well, can Seely capitalise? From 40 metres, has it swung back far enough? Yes.
So six goals to Seely. North down by 28 points. It's 94-122. They're kicking into a slight breeze as East force it over the boundary line here on grandstand wing. We've travelled 18 minutes of the last quarter. And East Ballarat edging irrepressibly closer and closer to that premiership that they've waited 3 years for. They won it in 89 and 90. North reversed it in 91 and 92. And it looks to be East's day in 93 as Cox comes bursting forward along the boundary. Will back big Alister. No, good spoil Kennedy. Well done Kennedy to force a rush behind. So 14-10-94 North. 19-9-123 East. I've got four down for six, gentlemen. I think that's right. Been a great day for Big Alister. Six at the other end of Seely. Here's the kick out from Kennedy. Reaches defensive 50. Little Orchard down. Got a bit of pace. He's well tackled this time. Still got the footy though. Inside to Odgers. He forces it across. Cox, well tackled. North with numbers. Hills, nice work to Buckley. And he'll run off defensive 50. He's working hard in this last quarter, the North captain, coach Robbie.
Trying to lift, give his players a bit of chance down there too. This is Ford, pushed at the last minute. The numbers come back. Smokey Dawson, centre wing, drives it in just inside 50. Big Ford buffled out of the way. The ball bounces, but I think it's going to be forced through and over the line. I thought for one fleeting moment it could have cleared the pack. Yeah, Jimmy Buckley lifted his own game since he's had a little bit of a spell on the bench.
Well, I think that, you know, really he knows that he's got a lead from the front here, and that's certainly what he's trying to do.
Big punch, the back of the pack, Stuart Brown. Right underneath the scoreboard, far side of the ground, grandstand side. Brown, McInerney it was, got the handball out. But it's East Ballarat chipping away to Ford, spins on the left boot. Could he get this one? No. It's going to go over the line and out of bounds. No, it does stay in. Oh, a leg break, keeps it in play. Fighting in there is Gladman. Over the top of the ball, no player really making any effort. But then again, it's been a furious 3 3/4 of football.
Well, Alister Ford's kicked goals from all angles today. Just over the 4,000 mark here today, and that would give us a gate of around about the $20,000 mark. So well done to the Ballarat Footy League. Been played in terrific conditions this grand final between two highly talented teams. I was just going to say, Alister Ford's kicked some mighty goals today, and he really is playing on adrenaline when he's trying left foot snaps from the forward pocket. And as you say, Rob, if it had a leg broken, Shane Warne style, that one might have gone through as well, as Buckley wins another possession, but straight up and down. I reckon that breeze is worth a couple of goals out there as Whyte takes it
chips it across in the direction of O'Donohue. He gets it to his other long sleeve man in crime in Orchard. They're rising here as they get it to Wolak. He'll go for home with a bomb. And the North defenders rush it through from behind.
I think North are pushing back too far into their back line at the moment. Really, there's nothing along their centre line or their half forward line to give them anything. And the only way they're going to win it is by attacking.
Well, to me, they've just had too many of their good players sitting on the sidelines.
Yes.
And the East Ballarat side have taken it right up to them. North, this fellow's tried hard. Cushion. And he'll kick from centre half back. Goes wide. Is that Buckley out there underneath the ball? No, it's not. Looks like it could have been Lewis. Advantage played. This is Buckley, though. Can't mistake the Grey Fox on this occasion. Kicks it out wide looking for Quinlan. And Quinlan will mark. Quinlan sets it up short. You look out there, is that all? Deep in the pocket it is. I shouldn't say deep in the pocket. It's between the pocket and half-forward flank. Now, Johnny Orr, knowing how he can kick a football, and I don't want to put the moz on you, Johnny boy, but I think you should be able to put this one through. Or left foot stabs at it though, and it's gone through from behind. No, it hasn't. 19-10, 19-10, 24 points the difference, Ian Baker.
Yes, still going to be a very hard job to do. I'd say that, you know, really, he should have this one.
10 minutes left. 8 or 10 minutes, Shane Healy, can they get back?
Not impossible, they keep ploughing on. You've got to give them absolute credit. They're kicking into a breeze in this last quarter. They started the term 4 goals down, they find themselves 22 minutes later. 4 goals down, Buckley is giving them a hell of a lot of work out of that centre.
Well, we're willing them to get back into it, but East Ballarat deserve everything they've got. Led by 17 at the first change, 48 points at half-time, and the Roosters whittle it back to 23 at three-quarter time.
O'Donohue of East takes it, hand passes inside to O'Connell. That's Peter, he was going to be in trouble. Gave it away, Buckley playing a masterful last quarter, leading from the front, works it across here, and now it's on the end of it, Orr. And Johnny Orr on the left foot, up beyond 50, a mark here would be handy. They just can't take it. Chance for a goal. Let's see, Lewis. He missed two in the first. He's missed three. You would not think that was possible, Ian Baker.
No, gee whiz, that was an easier goal than that.
Well, that would have only made it 3 goals the difference. This is still in play, this ball. Well done, East defenders. And now this is the boy number 7, Tony Evans. He'll work it along half-back flank and chip it to his Shirley Temple buddy in crime. And that is Wayne Dawson. And both have been pretty fair contributors today. I reckon off the back line, Evans, who was a surprise move there, as Ian said, was selected at centre-half forward, has done a great job. Here's another pretty fine player over four quarters. Marcus Wolak. And Wolak goes to Whyte. Just couldn't take it. Gladman was on the lead. Danny Holloway was with him. We've got a throw in 35 metres away from the East Ballarat goals. It's just below those magnificent trees around the circumference of this beautiful city oval. In one of the finest regional cities in the world, beautiful Ballarat. Here's the tap down. Cox works it to Orchard, or is that O'Donohue? It was O'Donohue. He goes to big Gladman. Oh, just didn't pay it. It sat there in the chest for a moment. The East supporters were willing it to stay there, but it fell out and we've got a bounce.
Yes, I think very unlucky, probably not to be paid.
Forward it is, pushed in the back, play on, says the umpire, good decision too. North got to be quick, they've got to get it out of that pack pocket and move quickly. And they do, keeping it in play. This is Sean Holloway. Holloway looks for options. There's only one on centre wing. At the back, the fall of the ball, handball, Poggenhorn. Couldn't get it away. East, tireless in defence. Good football, O'Connell. As Shane Healy said before, good one-handed mag, very casual from Chris Hills, and he's off. As Shane Healy said before, has been a great can set it up. Johnny Orr, been a good try. Left foot, far side, still a bit of time for them. This is Andrew Ford. Has a chance now to put this to centre-half forward. Where's the lead? Looks for the posture, Petey Kidd, he's not there, Sealy. In towards the centre of the ground.
I thought he had it, Rob.
Back again. East Ballarat, kick smothered. North left, Buckley. Oh, it was a throw, but he got away with it. And they've got to dig in. You can't wait for the ball to come to your son. He's got the advantage now, though. This is Quinlan. I thought he just waited and propped a little too long, Ian Baker.
Yes,
and
certainly.
A shocking kick, though. Or is it Mark? No, over the line and out of bounds.
Now a free kick, Rob. Free kick's been paid.
Well, North Ballarat still in this with a chance. This is Stuart Brown. Brown has one goal to his credit, and that came in the third quarter. And this one will need to be a bottler.
Well, if he kicks it, they've got to get three goals in time on. We're just ticking into time on right now.
It's going to be a miraculous kick if he kicks it from there. He's a left footer.
Brown comes in to try. We'll need to put a bit of a banana onto it. And I don't think this is far away. Oh. It's there! 124 plays 106. Have a look at this one on replay.
I'm still getting over it. And that was a fantastic left footer. We're into time on. North's three goals down. It's not beyond them. East look like premiers, but here they come out of the centre. North needed to work it out of the centre there. They didn't.
Two minutes left, Shane.
2 minutes left. I think East are home. White's knocked up getting kicks. He puts it into the forward line. Out comes his opposition number one, Kennedy. He'll chip it to Johnny Orr, having a big last quarter. Orr goes to Sean Holloway. He's been great since half-time. Holloway to centre half forward. Here's Buckley again. No losers at this time. To Peter O'Connell. Important turnover. Knocked forward again by Evans. Yeah, no. Down to Wolak. Oh, and he's got Stevens all on his own. And Stevens has got it. And you can say goodnight now, Noel. If there was any possible glimmer, smidgen of hope, it has just been unsmidgen.
Eddie's score makes it four goals. They lead by three.
They can't possibly get back. We're inside 2 minutes, say the official timekeepers. And here is Stevens. Today, he's kicked one goal, yes. Say two now, Robbie. The Bulldogs are premiers. Stevens has got two. Actually, Ian Baker, he's been an important Lynch player for them because he's allowed Ford to have a rest every now and again. He's taken a few good marks.
Yeah, for sure. And he's played very, very well. And I think that's been one of their avenues to goal. And Alistair's certainly been another. And they've had Dawson and they've had Gladman. And I think Rob hit it on the nail on the head there before, that they've had just too many good players. And a lot of the North players just haven't come up.
Too many avenues to goal. East Ballarat back to the centre of the ground. Dying stages of this 93 grand final. The weight goes in and the little bit of leather stays in the centre of the ground.
Just talking to my old mate Harry Sims, Rexy and Redan in 19...
Oh, Rob. Rex is the other bloke you work with.
Sorry, Rob. looking back to the records, 1953, they were in exactly the same position as North. Won every single game after being premiers the year before and lost the grand final to Golden Point. It's amazing. 40 years later, history exactly repeating itself.
This is shattering stuff for North Ballarat to go through, but that's why we play grand finals. It's a different ball game. It's a new game of football on grand final day. If you deserve to get there, you deserve to win it. The handball's on. Look at this. Look at the options being opened up here. Ian Baker, they go for home from inside 50. Wolak shut the gate. It's home.
Well, I think that just caps off the momentum of the game all day today, Rob. That they really have used the ball. They've been prepared to really work hard. And sometimes they look like they've been a little bit defensive and they've tried to hold the game. But when they've got their whole game running, they look really good.
Two great coaches on the ground, and Gary Odgers and, of course, Jimmy Buckley. I don't know what you've done to this side, Gary Odgers, but you've fired them up to an extent that I didn't think you would have probably knocked off this North Ballarat combination at the start of the day.
Well, I came up here into the box after hearing Odgers speak, and I was fired up, Robbie. I was ready to mud wrestle you.
Maybe we're in the wrong rooms.
He was
back into the centre.
He was fantastic down there, Odgers, early. And I repeat that comment he said to Gladman as they were doing exercises. He said, there's only 20 black and white so-and-sos standing, Glads, between us and glory. He was fired up, and here come North into their forward line. Doesn't matter. Blood might very well have the last possession of the day. No, that'll go to O'Donohue. Here comes the bell. O'Donohue kicks down to centre-half forward, and Wolak can't take the mark. We've got about 4 or 5 seconds left. And here she comes. East are premiers. That is one of the most amazing sights you will ever see, as young Evans hug Simpson and Jax, and they all jump in to celebrate. This team was the only team that
that ran North inside 50 points this year. That was back in the home and away series on a wet day at the Eastern Oval. But on the day that counted, Robbie Gaylard, I've got the name right this time. They've done it, and done it magnificently.
Done it magnificently, certainly, and good sportsmanship. Jimmy Buckley went over there, congratulated the opposition, and have a look at those Bulldog supporters out in the centre of the ground. They are absolutely ecstatic.
I think a premiership always feels and tastes a lot better when you're the underdog and really no one expects you to win.
Well, we saw the underdog get up into the Latrobe Valley this year. It was a bit one-sided in the Bendigo Football League. South Bendigo going there as the premiers for 1993. And North Ballarat stamping themselves as one of the best sides in regional and country footy for the last 3 years, biting the dust to the Bulldogs, East Ballarat. Congratulations, Gary Odgers. Commiserations to North Ballarat. 49, going for their 50th in a row, and it would be a shattering time for them.
I'll tell you what, if anyone today ever thought that there is a certainty in football, it has been disproven just absolutely beautifully on this magnificent football oval.
Actually, it's funny you say that, because you'll walk onto a ground, whether it be legal or illegal, whatever you like to say, there's always somebody that wants to have 50 here, 100 there, you know, just on the side. You know, there was not one person I saw want to have a bet here today. Maybe the East Ballarat players knew something that we didn't.
Maybe right. In fact, I said to you in the preview, Rob, that there's been a lot of barking around the town that East had one hell of a chance here. The St Kilda boys thought they could do it. And listen to that song chanting out, Bakes. I know that you're black and white through and through after your Redan days, but I'll tell you what, these red, white and blues, they played beautifully, led by the biggest man in Ballarat footy. What a player. If it was his last game, what a way for Alister Ford to go out.
I think someone might have misunderstood what he meant by his last game. It might have been his last game in the Ballarat Football League, because I know he's got a lot of ambition of coaching, and certainly after today's performance, if there's other people out in the country have looked at his game today, they'd be certainly after Alister Ford.
Put a price in your head, big fellow. I think you'll be a welcome commodity just around a few of the clubs.
Yes.
Well, as I said before, commiserations to North Ballarat. Congratulations. I'd love to know if John Dunn down there has got Gary Odgers, because I don't think he'd be able to put two words together at the moment. But we'll work on that. But it's just a scene of ecstasy out there at the moment. In fact, Jimmy Buckley has his boys in a huddle over there, and I just wonder perhaps what he'd be saying to them, because when you are the loser, Ian Baker, it's a very lonely time out there in the centre of the ground when the winners around you are celebrating.
Yes, it is very hard to take, and especially if you go into the final as the firm favourites as North were, and I can remember back in 1988, we were the same way, and it is very hurting, I can tell you, but it's like any game in any sport. You know, you've got to take the good with the bad, and today, you know, they were beaten by a far better side. There's no doubt about that. You look through East side there and you can pick a number of good players. Look through some of the North Ballarat side and really, you know, you'd be struggling to see any of the good performers playing well.
Talking of good performers, Shane Healy, let's take a run down and try and pick out some of the better players for North. I don't think you're going to have too many troubles on the Bulldog side of the ledger.
Well, I just circled these players for North, and Bakes, you add any to this list and correct me if you disagree. I thought Sean Holloway was a four-quarter contributor. I thought Wes Lewis lowered his colours early to O'Connell. By the end of the day, even though they didn't play side by side, I thought you could say Lewis at least was a good player, but those three misses, absolutely critical. Michael Troon out of defence. I thought Grant Polkinghorne's vision and options, time and time again, he set up goals by choosing the correct option. Caius Ryan, a good contributor all day. And I suppose for his last quarter effort, you'd have to say Jimmy Buckley at the last just lifted himself for one dying effort. On the other side of the ledger, gee whiz, Paul Whyte, Peter O'Connell, Gary Odgers, Marcus Wolak, Tony Evans, Alister Ford, and of course Little Orchard.
Well, we have a look at it quarter by quarter. 27-44 in the first quarter and a margin of 17 points. 41-89. East Ballarat really blew it out for a 48-point margin at half-time. They chipped it back to 23, the Roosters, but the final margin, as we see it on the Gillies Brothers scoreboard, or the Gillies Pies scoreboard, 16-10-106. They went down North Ballarat to 21-10-136. Gary Odgers, I'm sure, is down there somewhere, and I think Gary Odgers is down there somewhere with John Dunn. We'll keep our fingers crossed, because it's a melee down there, and hopefully we'll go down there and pick him up. JD, have you got him there with you?
Certainly have. Thanks very much, Rob. A very, very jubilant Gary Odgers. Gary, congratulations. The pre-game plan was to run the North Ballarat players off their legs. It seemed to have worked.
Yeah, well, that was certainly the plan. You know, we just felt that quite a few of their players hadn't played many games over the last 4 or 5 weeks, and there's no doubt with all our youngsters and that, there goes pace and to move the ball quickly. So that was our plan before the game. We just felt they might have been a little bit underdone, and, you know, I mean, there's sort of a bit of a history there at the moment. You saw Essendon do it last week, and I kept pumping that into our players during the week, that if we really kept running, if they're a little bit short of match practice, it'll find them out, and I think that's what happened in the end.
Gary, that the young players grew in stature after that good start.
Yeah, well, of course I did. I mean, look, it's a big experience for any young fella to play in their first grand final, and I thought our young fellas acquitted themselves very well. They asked, you know, they did exactly what I asked of them, and, you know, look, it's a credit to them. They're terrific young fellas as well, so, you know, their family, and that should be proud of them too.
Gary, congratulations. We'll let you go and celebrate.
Thanks very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much, Johnny Dunn. I was going to try and get you to ask him, is there another 12 months left in Greece? Congratulations, Gary Odgers, anyhow, but he's gone to celebrate with his players. I've had an absolute ball back in the old hometown here this afternoon. On behalf of my co-commentators in Shane Healy and Ian Baker, I speak on behalf of Alan Besley and John Dunn. We've had a ball. Congratulations, East Ballarat. You've caused the boil over. Commiserations to North. We'll see you next time at a footy ground somewhere near you.
This has been an SCN Sport presentation. Thompson Video, your professional production house. 331-776.
The Ballarat Football League Grand Final was proudly brought to you by Barry Smith Motors and Carlton and United Breweries.